Maker, and welcome to Designer Inspiration. It's lush to have you all on board. My name is Rebecca Redican. Do feel free to call me Becky though. And I have got lots of treats to get your Sunday going today. I am joined by the lovely guest designer. It's Frankie.
Hi Becky, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Not
how are
good,
you?
Anyway. I'm all right, thank you. Yeah.
What are we going to get from you today, lovely Frankie?
Well, I've got polymer in both kits. And then something you had yesterday, which seemed to go really well. I've got some little things in bottles.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say any more.
Yes, we've got kind of a bit of a mixed media in a weird way today, haven't we?
Yeah.
What are we expecting for your first designer inspiration?
Well, it's one that I teased on my guest designer page. It's I'm going to do a dragonfly.
A dragonfly.
He's rather large.
He is. He's a quite a statement.
Rather spectacular.
he's a statement, isn't
he's
he?
He's definitely a statement.
He's a statement piece. Yes. And what about any second designer inspiration, huh?
Well, lots of people when I last had clay said they liked the fish that I did. So I've done a couple of fishes. So I'm going to do.
We've done some fish.
Yes,
some fishes. They are coming up for you this afternoon. We've got two designer inspirations. Frankie's with us till 5, so send in a text, why don't you? 60777 is our text number, or you can get involved, of course, on JewelleryMaker.com if you want to. Send us any messages in that you might like, any questions you might have. Here's a message straight away, apparently.
Good.
Yay! Stay pumped, Frankie! So good to see you back on JM screen. Looking forward to a great show. Hugs from Sue.
Oh, thank you, Sue. I think that's probably Sue Smutterly, I think her name is. Yes. Thank you, Sue. That's really kind of you.
Bless you. Thanks, Sue. Do feel free to message us in any questions or comments you might have throughout the show. I have got something really special today. I have got two cabochons that you don't want to miss out on. Well, two sets, let's say. One of them is an individual cabochon, and it is, let's just say it is history suspended in time. Any ideas? I've also got for you one of the highest qualities of black star dioxide cabochons we've ever seen. I've got a collection of those coming up for you today, and it is that ever so sought after 4-star that we are looking for. It is one of the rarest of all black star dioxides I've got for you today, and they will be under £40 for the selection. All right, they'll be under £35. I've got loads coming up for you today. Let's start off with a band, shall we? We are going to be bringing you some stunning strands today. I'm talking imperial topaz, I'm talking a high-end strand of peridot, and whenever we're working with really high-end pieces, we need high-end materials to go alongside it, and that is why these are perfect. 925 sterling silver earrings. Now, these are seriously sizable, aren't they? Do you know what I absolutely love about these? How usable they are. Because, I mean, look at them. You have got here your long earrings. We could just wear them like this, realistically, couldn't we, if we wanted to? Because you have got 3 pairs of these. But these can be worked so, so, so easily to create links, to create a chain effect. If you wanted to loop up this side or even do a swirl on it to make it a little bit shorter, if maybe the big gorgeous dramatic effect wasn't for you. Or what about if you're into, which I know a lot of people are, those gorgeous wirework dragonflies that Rachel Norris inspired many to get involved with. How about using these as a wing base? Because they're the perfect shape for it, aren't they? They're absolutely perfect shape for it. You have got in here 3 pairs, so you're getting 6 of these in total. Well done to everyone who's already getting these. You have got so many uses and so much versatility with these. I've already got lots of people on the web who I've checked out, and that's possibly because you can see the price point of these. These are dramatic, these are dynamic. Let me get a sizing on these for you, because I'm just having a look up here and it hasn't got the sizings on them. Let's have a little look. Height-wise, so from ball drop to kind of the pinnacle point, as it were, I'm looking at around 5 centimetres, so about a 50mm drop that we've got on here. So really heavy weight of 925 then, a lot of weight in here. You're looking at 5 grams worth. Now that is way over the average amount you'll find in an engagement ring. Average amount in an engagement ring is around, being safe, it's around 3 grams. So you've got way more than of those precious metal than you would find in your average engagement ring. And what prices are we usually expected to pay for an engagement ring? Well, obviously it makes a big difference, doesn't it? It makes a huge difference depending on what stone you've got, what workmanship's gone into it, and where exactly you're buying it. But you can be paying hundreds and hundreds of pounds, can't you? And of course that precious metal is kind of one of the go-to pieces of why people, and why lots of people get their hands on it. Hello, lovely Alex, you're in again today. Lovely to see you, sweet. We've got serious high-end metal weight here. So we should be expecting a serious price point, shouldn't we? No, this is Jewellery Maker. £6.95 for you today. For all of these, £6.95. That's your price point on these today. Get them whilst you can, because I've got so many gemstones coming up for you today that you're going to want £95 to pair with, probably. Things like your black spinel, things like a really high-end strand of peridot. Gorgeous imperial topaz I've got coming up for you as well. And I have got some, Pete, I know you can, what am I thinking of? What's that thing I've got coming on today that'll go good with 925? Come on, brother Pete, we're meant to be connected here as siblings. No, it's a gemstone. Sapphire! Thanks for reminding.
I knew it.
You knew it. I knew you did. Alex. Hi, Frankie and Becky. Looking forward to the partnership this afternoon. Any sterling silver, please? That worked out well, didn't it, Alex? Didn't it? We have got some 95. It's right on your screen now. Your code is RHRF79. Yay! Can't wait to see how to do the fish. I love the last one. Frankie, the necklace you have on looks awesome. Looking forward to the show, and that's from Shelley. Hi, Shelley.
Thank you, Shelley. It's my pride and joy, I have to say.
Your necklace?
Yes.
Yeah. Phil just went, wait, is that her daughter? Pride and joy. No, she means a necklace.
My daughter is my pride and joy.
It's too late now, Frankie. Too late.
Okay, I'll stop digging.
Your names have gone off my screen, so well done to see everybody. Lots of triple bios on that. I've got 100 metres of wire coming up for you soon. I think this is possibly one of the last lots of 100 metres of wire you'll ever see. Got a fair few of them. Let's add something really spectacular and really high-end that I'm about to bring you now. Because you've just bought your 95, you're going to want something special to go with it, aren't you? And this truly, truly is special. Can I have that slide behind me, please, Ryan? This is a gemstone which is formed in such a unique and individual way. It's formed very, very closely to the way in which diamond is formed. It's just that diamond is formed slightly lower down in the mantle. You have got kind of behind us here, if you can take a look, you can see that this isn't actually the crust. The crust of the earth is kind of around here. Where this is formed is around about 250 miles through the centre of the earth, so to this crust. And essentially what happens is, with things like tectonic movement and plate movement, what happens is pressure changes and heat changes, and obviously the shape of the land changes. And what happens is the kind of elements of this gemstone are pushed from the mantle all the way up through volcanic eruptions vast majority of the time, and that's how they get to the crust of the earth for us. Now, because of that amount that they have travelled, because of all this tectonic movement, because of all this heat and all this pressure, it gives this gemstone and diamond something really spectacular, and that is a not to be missed sparkle. And boy, you have got it on this strand. Natural, stunning, wonderful peridot. You've got to be quick. I've not got many of these available whatsoever. Never ever been seen before. Brand spanking new for you today. 30 carats worth here of that peridot. You've got that sparkle. You've got that beautiful, bright, out of this world. Well, out of this world, let's say, further down in the mantle colouring that you would not normally expect to see on gemstones that have travelled so far. You'd expect to kind of see all these fiery tones, wouldn't you? But peridot stands against that test with all of its beautiful, beautiful elements that make up this gorgeous, sparkling gemstone. It has travelled a long, long distance to be with you today. It's the first time you've ever seen it, and your price point today is a shocker. £6.95 for you today. You yourself can make yourself a stunning pair of say earrings, or even if you did a little bit of wire work around here, and maybe you wire worked in like Jan did on the morning show this morning. You know, when she encapsulated those diamonds she had in that kit this morning. Quarter of my stock is in baskets, you need to check those out. You could actually encase some of these peridot around the outside and use that as a beautiful, beautiful 925 and peridot pendant, and imagine how much you would be selling that for. I mean, come on, you're getting it for less than £15 for both today. That is exceptional value. It really, really is. Half of my stock has gone on this right now. It is a brand spanking new strand, and it is sensational. Nobody expected that price, did they? Well done to everyone who's coming in for this. Oh, hello, Fleur. Not just getting the one. It is sensational, isn't it? Well done to absolutely everybody who's getting your hands on this today. Say that to me again, please, pop it. Lots of you with it in your basket, £6.95. Do check out those baskets. I'm being told that I've got 15 in baskets at this moment in time. I've got massive amount of these going, flying out of the door. I've now got more in baskets than I have quantity. So do make sure you check out, because right now we're going down to fastest finger first. Oh, wow. What? Well, those graphics having a little party. Had a text in. Hi Becky, hi Steampunk Frankie, my favourite designer. So looking forward to your designs. I'm the Joe you thanked on Facebook.
Oh right, okay Joe, thank you very much indeed. Thank you again. Thanks for sending in a message, that's really kind of you.
Well done, they're about to sell out. Congratulations everyone who got those. Feel free to keep your texts coming in, lovely ladies and gentlemen. You know that you've got the 925, don't you? We've already got that kind of with us. I'm about to add to it now something which is constantly compared to diamonds. And that's because when it comes to lustres, this, for a black gemstone, is the closest realistically you can get. It is the most stunning, crafted spinel. It's beautiful. Imagine if this were diamond. Okay, I know it's not at all, it's not. There's a lot of similarities between this and diamond, a lot. Luster being one of them, the luster of this and a black diamond is very, very similar. Also, the strength of it on a Mohs scale is relatively similar. Obviously, it's not as strong as a diamond, which is a 10 on the Mohs scale, but this gemstone is pretty much only beaten in hardness by sapphire, ruby, and diamond. So really, really, really strong, strong, strong gemstone, especially if you think about all of the variety of gemstones that are out there. To only really be beaten in strength by three other gemstones is pretty, pretty kind of no mean feat, realistically. This means that you can wear these for day wear, you can use these in rings, you can use these in bracelets. And I say that because when we think about certain gemstones and when we think about certain pieces such as your bracelet and your ring, we know that those are areas where realistically you want to be working with those stronger those stronger gemstones, because at the end of the day, you know, with the amount we use our hands and kind of you know, scratching possibilities that you can get with bracelets and rings, you want a strong gemstone that can stand up to that kind of everyday wear and tear. And boy oh boy, these ones can. They are absolutely exquisite. Now this, I need to say to you, is not a low cost bundle. I know sometimes we do bundles for you with, you know, two or three strands in around 10 or £12, which is a fabulous price point. This bundle is not of that caliber. This is 10, 11, 12 steps higher for many, because at the end of the day, you have spinel in here. What is my quantity on this, please, lovely Phil? Okay, listen, ladies and gentlemen, I've got around 60 of these available. Now, that may sound like a lot, but I can assure you it's not when this quality is so, so abundant and so, so obvious. The amount of spinel you're getting on here is almost unfathomable, because if you look, no spaces on here whatsoever. They're all kind of overlapping and butting up against each other because we have just squeezed on as many as we can on this strand. If this were to be a diamond strand, I wouldn't even like to hazard a guess as to the price point that this would come to, even at our prices. I know we did a strand of faceted black diamonds, and I think you got five of the faceted black diamonds, and they were rice bead shapes, and they were £169-ish, and that was for five. So if this were to be diamond, even at Jewellery Maker prices, oh my gosh, a grand? More than that, probably. It's not, though. It is spinel. It has a lot in common with diamond, but one thing it doesn't is most certainly the price. It's an absolutely sensational strand. I completely adore this. You're also getting within this a top drilled strand of your crackled quartz as well. It's got a beautiful air and edge to it. It's a real nice juxtaposition between that gorgeous kind of high shine faceted effect that we have of that wonderfully lustrous spinel, and then you've got that internal crackle that kind of dispels and displaces the light within the gemstone. You have got just a stunning collection here. Your price point today for both is not £24.90. That price point isn't even the RRP. It should be more than that, because the spinel is worth more than that, but it has been taken down recently. £19.95 for you today is your price point. It is absolutely sensational. I mean, come on, these pieces are a wonder. They truly, truly are. You've got 165 carats worth on that black spinel, and they're up to 9x6mm. And then you've got the top drill crackle quartz as well, which are around an 8x6mm for you today. £19.95 for you. Get it whilst you can at that price point. There's 10 of these in baskets. Make sure you are checking these out whenever you get the opportunity to do so, because it is an absolute bargain. Well done to everybody. You are going to be adding to your collection some serious sparkle with some serious glamour. And let's face it, it's kind of timeless elegance as well, isn't it? Oh, hello, Cass. We've got some budding beader makes of this, have we? Oh, lovely. Oh, they're pretty. Who's done these ones? It's lovely Susan. Hello, lovely. Take a little look. I'm just trying to catch... Let me just swing it. Catch the light on it. It's nice light translation through that, isn't there? And you've got a pair of earrings as well. Oh, look how cutesy these are. They're double-sided as well. Little flowers. £19.95. Check out your baskets whilst you can. This is a beautiful monochrome glamour collection. Nice work. There's still lots sat in blastics. You know what I mean. Get out of your baskets, you. Where to? Tiger's Eye. Oh my gosh, you're going to love these cabochons. Have a little look at this gorgeous tiger's eye. Oh no, I'm accidentally showing the wrong one. Oh, that is so unfortunate. That's coming off in a bit. They're in the same pot. What am I supposed to do? I thought it was tiger's eye. I have got for you some gorgeous tiger's eye cabs, and these are truly sensational. They're blue tiger's eye cabochons. Let me show you the absolute beauty of these. So hard to catch it in the light correctly. Oh, that is so, so delectable, isn't it? Everyone, just take a moment, put the iron down, step away from the kettle, and just enjoy this. That is sensational, isn't it? Low stock opportunity on these. You get your heart-shaped cab, which is around a 40 by 30, and you get, oh sorry, you get a 35 cab, and then you get the drop, which is around 40 by 30 as well. Price point on these today, low stock opportunity, great quality, is just lowest possible price we're going to go straight to. We've not got time to mess around today. I've got a lot of products to get through, so let's do it properly. $6.95 for you today on two cabochons of this quality is absolutely sensational. You can see the quality just banding around these. There's so much help out there on our YouTube if you've never worked with cabochons before. If you've got any of your really beautiful mesh ribbon that we've had in recently, then this is one of the easiest ways to wrap a cabochon. It takes absolute moments, but gives you such a high-end effect. And the great thing about working with these types of things, with the meshes, even if you do cover up a little bit of the gemstone, because it's mesh, you can still see through it. So you still get that beautiful kind of shiller effect underneath the surface of these. Get them whilst you can, because they are beautiful quality. Not many of these sticking around whatsoever. You are getting genuine, real deal tiger's eye for £6.95. So they're working out, well, about £3.50 per one, aren't they? Which, come on, you can't really complain at that, can you? It is sensational. Say that to me again. That well-known hobbying store doesn't actually do genuine gemstone cabochons at all anymore. They used to, they don't anymore. But ones that you can buy, plastic ones that you are buying in there at the moment, even those are around the £8, £9 per one. Why bother when you can get the genuine real deal? And let's face it, you know, kind of the notoriety of working with the real gemstone, and it's a lower price point, that's going to work out better for us all, isn't it? Well done, everyone. Low stock opportunity. And if you do want to wrap yourself a cab, or if you do want to make your own earring findings, or if you are just missing 100 meters worth of wire, I may well have one of your last ever opportunities here at Jewellery Maker to get your hands on 100 meters worth. Check it out, 100 meters worth of wire. You have got your 0.8 wire here. Well done to everybody who's already kind of getting themselves on the phone, getting ready to purchase this, because let's face it, we have not seen 100 meters worth of wire for a long time. I'm really, really chuffed to say I've got a decent enough quantity of this for you today. But what I will say is, how can I put this best? Let's just say this is the last time you're going to see this this product. Even if we don't sell out of this product right here, right now, what we'll be doing is we'll be putting it into our shop, or we'll just be taking a hit on it and making a loss on it completely, because at the end of the day, we've got no more space in the workshop for it. We made a promise to the people who are making our 50 meter spools now that we said we wouldn't be selling any more 100 meter reels from a certain date and from a certain time, and that is around the corner. So let's just say, get this whilst you can, because after today, even if I don't sell out, you will not be seeing this again. It's as simple as that. So get it whilst you can. You have got here your gorgeous 0.8 red colored wire. The great thing with this that I know so many of you missed the 100 meters. The great thing with 100 meters is you've got the opportunity there to make, and you've still got plenty left over. I would say to you that I know it seems a ridiculously long way off, and I'll be honest, I never thought that in February I would say this, but even if you're thinking that around Christmas time you're going to be looking, I know I'm not meant to say that word, but I just had to, because it's the perfect colour. It's the perfect colour, and if you think you're going to be making plenty of you know, Christmas stockings or Santas or you know, kind of the Alison Terry Robins, etc., then you're going to need this. And you know, especially with those very, very heavily wire worked pieces, you need a lot of wire. We've got it here. Don't miss out, because I am taking the price down. You have got 100 meters worth here of your high quality red colored copper wire. Your price is going down, lowest we can see. See you, bye. $14.95 for you on that one today. It is absolutely sensational price point, isn't it, Frankie?
I'm saying, just buy it to practice. I mean, it, that price for 100 meters, just practice with it if you're not very, you know, if you're just into wire work. I mean, it's 0.8. It's just going to do it for you, isn't it? It's an amazing price.
It's stunning, isn't it?
It is, definitely.
It is absolutely stunning. Great for rings. Great for kind of the baseline of wrapping your cabochons. Great for earring findings as well, if you want to as well. It is just sensational. £10 back in your pocket. It's beautiful red colouring that we have here. The great, great, great quality that we have on here is sensational. You're not really, really likely, unless you're very rough with it, to kind of get any of that colour loss. You've got that beautiful kind of vibrant, really, post-box red. There's loads and loads and loads on the phones, I'm being told, so do stay exactly where you are. What would you be doing with this wire and this colouring, Frankie?
Well, all sorts of things. I bought some fire opal the other day, and that would go beautifully. You know, it's the shaded strand.
Yeah.
So it's got some of the darker ones as well as the paler ones. And that red would be beautiful with some of the fire opal.
Really make it pop.
Yeah, absolutely gorgeous.
Mm.
Yep.
We've got some examples with 0.8 wire, do we? Oh, obviously they are different colours, but this is exactly the same wire.
Yes.
When it comes to the thickness, so you can see there's loads you could do with this. It's strong enough to be used with your bangles as well. You can use it on rings, as we said, and you can see there. Oh, spellbinding pieces. I haven't seen her in yonks. It's been at least a week and a half. It's far too long. Beautiful ring pieces you've got there as well. And you can create all those looks with this. Obviously, it's just going to be in a different colour palette, a different colourway. Hello to everybody who's coming in. It's lovely to see you again, Raymond and Joanne. You're a lovely pair. Anita, you're back with us today as well. Victoria in Cheshire. I'm heading up back to Cheshire tonight. I hope traffic's not bad again. It took me 4.5 hours the other day to get home. 4.5 hours, yeah. It's 125 miles, usually takes you about 2.5. 4.5 hours. Eva, you're coming in as well in Greater Manchester. Lots of people from all over coming in. It's lovely to see you. Well done, everyone who's getting these, because genuinely, I've got a really decent quantity. I've got over 200 of this. I've probably got, well, your names have gone off my screen. I don't know exactly how many have gone, but I've got plenty of these, but realistically, once this 100 meter spool is gone, you're not seeing it again. It's essentially going to either be put in the shop or it will be scrapped, essentially. Essentially? I know. Essentially? We don't want to do that. Get it at a bargain. £10 off. £10 off today. £10 off. Get it whilst you can. Okie pokey. It's that time. I'm so excited I can do this right now. What did you say? Oh, I thought you said this is going to be unbelievable. Wow. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, before we even get the graphics in, that's a lie, we'll get them in now. I need to say to you something. This is so, so exciting to have back in. I can always see a wing in mine. Every single one of these, of course, is going to be different. This is such an exciting, exciting product to bring you. For me, I think this is one of the most exciting organics to bring you. I'm bringing it to the lowest price ever as well, just to make it more exciting. Why not? There's no managers in. You might have been able to tell by some of the morning show prices. There's no managers in, so we're just going wild today. Why not? Lowest ever price on this for no reason whatsoever, apart from we can. I have got for you here something that truly is just hit history, kind of frozen in time. I just love amber. Just look at the glow on this. You have got here a stunning, stunning amber collection, an amber cabochon. The lovely thing about the amber cabochons that I'm bringing to you right here, right now, is the fact that I am able to say to you, you will be getting a cabochon that is around, that is a 12 by 18, and it will be in this gorgeous kind of quirky teardrop shape. Now, it's lovely to be able to say that to you, because we can't always say that, can we, with our cabochons. You all right, Frankie, love?
Yes, sorry, I just kicked the bin.
Don't go kicking the bin, love.
Well, it wasn't the bucket.
God, she's a rebel, isn't she? Kicking the bin all over the place.
Sorry.
She will rock you.
Is that my first mistake?
You've got, seriously, it's kind of history captivated in time. It's lovely to be able to say, you'll definitely be getting this shape. You'll definitely be getting this shape and this sizing. Because with some of our cabs recently, in fact, with the black salt dioxide, for example, it's all done on carat weight. So I can only kind of estimate to you the amount you'll get. But with this, you have definitely got this shape and size. And it is that frozen history kind of in time. I love the fact that the youngest this will be is around 50 million years old. But it could be around 200 million years old. If you think, hello, loads of triple buyers and loads of multi-buyers, lovely to have you on board today. If you think, okay, about that as a history of time scale, when we think about organics, there's probably two that will spring to mind. One will be pearls and one will be this. Pearls, around about 10 years in the making per one. This, around 50 million years in the making. That is so exciting and so interesting. Essentially, if you're not totally sure how this is created, because let's face it, we very, 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 very rarely have amber on. If you're not totally sure how this is created, okay, well, what is it? It is a tree resin, essentially. And what happens is a tree, generally the monkey puzzle tree, so I'm not sure if you know what they look like, but they've kind of got kind of spiny-ish looking bark, and then they have these arms that go up, and they're almost fern-like in it, sort of, in appearance. And essentially what happens is the tree will be attacked. For example, one of the easiest examples would be, say, by a woodpecker, and it'll attack the bark. And as it gets to a certain point, it will kind of try and protect itself by releasing this resin. Now, the resin is completely unique and different to any other resin found in any other tree, because with resin in certain, you know, common garden, what you might have in your back garden kind of trees, that resin over time with rain and with weather conditions will essentially just dissolve. It'll just break away. This is totally different. It doesn't do that. It's so, so viscous and so, so sticky that what happens is natural organics and animals that can kind of brush past it will just get stuck in there. They'll get stuck into in place, and as this solidifies and as this hardens, they'll just be stuck there. So that's why it's kind of history frozen in time. We're going to be getting so many different looks. I would say to all of you who are buying, you know, two or three, there's a fair few of you, even though you're getting three and you know it's going to be the same size and the same shape, every single one's going to be different. I mean, you can see up here, I've got these little trapped organics. I see something in it that looks very, very much wing-like. And don't forget, you can have animals trapped in yours. You can have little mosquitoes. You could even have, some people find, kind of ferns, proper looking ferns that are attracted in there. Little creatures you find in there. And don't forget as well, I love this about it. You could actually have something trapped in your amber that is extinct now. That has been extinct for 40 million years, you could have trapped in your reeds. How amazing is that? It's like, this is exactly why whenever my director tech up Ben is in, he's off, by the way, today and yesterday, because if you saw him on Friday, he had a poorly tough, didn't he? So he's off. But this is why he always does the Jurassic Park theme whenever Amber's on. Because it is that ancient encapsulation. Ladies and gentlemen, who wants the lowest ever price today? Lowest ever price, Amber Cab. £6.95 for you on this today. This amber cab has always, well, no, it hasn't always been. It was £9.95 at start, wasn't it? It was £9.95 to start, and then it went down to, it was £7.95 was our suggested price. But actually, we're doing a launch price for it today, so I just need to really, really make this very, very clear. Very clear right here, right now. I can't promise that when you see this exact cab next time, it will still be the same price. I need to put that straight out there, because this is a premier price point. Our price point that it should be is $7.95, so that will be the prices you'll be looking at seeing. I have bought every piece of amber you have brought on air. It is fab. Even put them under a microscope to see the bugs and bits. Love it. And the show today. Karen, what a fab idea. Imagine looking this underneath a microscope. That'd be totally different. A microscope. How exciting would that be? Look at how you get that glow. Thanks for sending that in, Karen. I've got 20 in baskets. Oh, come back here. I've got 20 in baskets. How gorgeous would that be as a ring? I mean, realistically, it would be perfect, wouldn't it? What would you do with these, Frankie McGee?
I was going to say buy because I bought a couple sort of similar to that the other day. I'm going to make earrings, so I would make earrings with those, because as they dangle in your ears, the light would shine through.
Yeah.
Definitely. So I'd buy at least two. At least two.
I love that.
And probably more.
And probably more.
Well, at that price, I mean, goodness me.
You're rude not to.
If you go to, you know, the museums or, you know, sort of stately homes and whatever, and they've got gem places, you know, that you couldn't buy a piece of amber for that price.
No, you couldn't. No,
I
you
mean,
really
that's a,
couldn't.
It's a reasonable size. It's,
yeah.
You know,
12 by 18.
Yeah. So you wouldn't be able to buy a piece that cheap. No. Say cheap, that inexpensively, should I say.
Yeah, absolutely agree with that. Completely agree with that. What are you going to do with it then? Apart from earrings, what else? If you were going to buy three, what would you do with the
third? Oh, I'd make a pendant to match.
Of course. Of course.
I mean, some people would make a ring. I am into rings. I don't make very many rings. But you could make a beautiful ring, as you've said, and that's sitting on your hand so beautifully, isn't it? Like
it's
a lovely ring.
Stunning with that glow. Well done, everyone. Lots of quadruple buyers and triple buyers. Lowest price. Well done, everyone.
Fabulous.
Stunning. I have got black cell dioxide coming up for you in a little... Is it the eye time already? Blimey, Charlie, that has come real fast. What am
it
I expecting
has.
From your first DI, please, Frankie?
I'm going to make a dragonfly.
Ooh. Now, let's have a little look at what I've got in here. Oh, there's only one chance at the souffle game today, sorry.
Shucks.
I know. let's have a little look at exactly what we've got in here for you today. You've got three blocks of your polymer, gorgeous multimedia collection I've got here for you. You've got your grey granite, and when it says accents, just to let you know, it means something else has been added to give it a different appearance. So you can see these kind of speckles inside, that's your granite appearance. I've then got your denim of the Primo as well. And then lastly, but by no means leastly, I've got a souffle. Let's play the souffle game. Yay! If you don't know what the souffle game is, it's still a type of polymer. It just looks slightly different. It has a slightly different texture and feel to it and kind of hold to it. And when it's baked, it looks slightly different as well. It has a bit more kind of malleability to it post-bake, depending on how you work with it. But the Primo normal names, you know, blue, white, black, souffle, throw that out of the park. What colour is this? Brother Pete, you're up. That's what? Barney purple. Other imaginary dinosaurs are available. Sorry, not imaginary. He is real, I'm sure. Come on, what are you saying, Pete?
I'm saying blueberry excellence.
Blueberry excellence.
That's a good one.
Do you work for souffle? no, it is, of course, turnip.
Of course it is.
you were the closest, Pete, because you were along the food lines. So you are getting three packs of those in total, and then adding some wire to the collection as well. You've got that beautiful regal royal blue, and that is 1 mil, and then you are getting your delicate kind of aqua blue, which is a 0.4 that we have in there. I'm then gonna add some of your kind of additions, let's say, some of your extra pieces. Perfect for steampunk, of course, but also great for kind of the industrial age, kind of Victoriana, your vintage feels, purely due to the colours of these. So let's have a look. These are all Tim Holtz, as we know and love. Take a little look at what we've got here. You've got your clock faces. Five different clocks on there with different kind of timepiece decor on them as well. You then have that go perfectly the arms of this. These at the bottom, I know people ask a lot of the time. That's what you put through the centre of the clock and the centre of the arm, as it were, and that's what gives them the movement. And then we have the cogs as well. Lots of different shapes there. Now, you've used loads of these on the necklace you're actually wearing, haven't you?
Yes, definitely.
Lots and lots of these ones.
Yes.
These aren't just for jewellery making, of course. These are great if you're a paper crafter. Absolutely perfect for paper crafting. You can also inlay these into pieces as well if you wanted to. You can stick them on to things like your enamel and your resin too. You can do some beauty pieces with that. Say that to me, Em. What'd you say? Can you patina them?
Yes.
That'd be nice.
Yes.
What kind of colours would you patina these?
Well, any colour you like, really.
Oh, I love that idea.
Yeah.
Give it a real different look then.
Definitely.
Like
the thing is, you can rub off some of the colour as well to
sand it off.
Yeah, I've done that on in the next designer inspiration. You sand it off, and then you could add little bits, you know, with your finger or whatever.
Oh, I like that. Give it a nice little mottle.
Yes,
effect.
Definitely lovely.
Oh, really nice. I like that. So you've got loads of pieces in it, and then of course we've got the gemstones. If you got those tiger's eye cabs, then I would really say you probably should be getting this kit, because just look at how superbly they go together. Aren't they beautiful?
I'd never used the blue, Becky.
No, I hadn't,
and I just loved it when I'd finished the piece. I was really pleased with it.
It goes really well with your piece, actually, the colour palette you've got, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I've got your blue tiger's eye, and I have your red tiger's eye as well. These are both kind of your nuggets, let's say, your elongated nuggets, and you're up to around a 30 by 5 mil on these, which is nice. So not kind of your fiddly ones, if you're not really into those ones, or if you have dexterity problems, these are going to be slightly more usable, but still have that nice organic feel to them. Really beautiful chatoyancy bursting through both of these strands, actually. Then lastly, but by no means leastly, I've got this really lovely high shine black agate, around 400 carats worth on those ones. So we've got that gorgeous texture running through here, haven't we? Really, really beautiful effect. And you've also got that kind of interest bursting under the surface of these too. We are doing a massive price drop on this. We say that our average price drop of late has been around £14 to £15. We're going to beat that today. Anyone fancy exactly £15 back in their pocket?
Please.
That'd be good, wouldn't it?
Yes, please. Yeah, that'd be good.
Exactly. So this is going to end in 45, just so you know. It looks like a random number. I don't want to lie to you, though, so I won't. It's not £15. It's £20 back in your pocket today. £20 back in your pocket. That's almost half price. What do you think?
It's a brilliant kit to work with for that price. Goodness me. Well, it's a brilliant kit anyway, but at that price, I mean, you know, for the Tim Holtz findings, you know, we don't get them all the time, do we? So, you know, and those blue tiger's eye, you're right, they are absolutely lovely. I've never worked with them before. They've got such beautiful steampunk colours in them.
Haven't they? Really stunning.
Yeah.
And when we have a nosy at what you've done, I think even more people are going to be jumping on the phone lines. That's an amazing price point. I don't think we agreed on that price last. I don't mind. I ain't complaining. I am not complaining. Let's head on over to you. Oh, you've made some lovely, lovely pieces. I adore how you've got kind of the steampunk running through, but you've also got the polymer taking hold. You've also managed to get some crochet in there as well.
Couldn't resist, Becky.
Of course not. Why would you? I have got some Eslon coming up for you later, and it's one of the biggest bundles of Eslon I've ever seen. Normally, we do Eslon kind of 3 and 6s, don't we? Not today. More than that. But low quantity on those. Take a little look at exactly what we've got on offer for you here today. This is the one we're going to be learning to make, isn't it?
Yep.
It's a really, really funky design. And then the one next to it. Tell me about this one, Frankie.
Well, you know, everybody likes a tree of life. And I wanted to do something different. That blue wire is so gorgeous. And it went so well with the blue tiger's eye that I decided I'd make a tree of life and put the cogs and the clock and whatever it into the tree branches instead of bees or whatever. So that's what that is. That's the tree of life.
And then the one next to this one, you've added a bit of crochet too.
I did, yes. That wire comes in the bundle as well. And so I crocheted...
Is that the 0.4?
Yes, it's the 0.4. So I crocheted... I used most of that, to be honest. I had a little bit left. But I used that in a circular fashion.
Yeah.
I think we showed that last time I was crocheting, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
And then, that's the Egyptian oh, what's it called? That's on there.
Oh, the scarab.
The scarab, mm-hmm. And I chopped off part of his body and put one of the steampunk cogs on there as well, so.
Yeah, can you see that? You can see the wings behind. And then lastly, but by no means leastly, you've got the long piece, which is really nice, and we've used the bezel for this one as well, which I have got, yes. The bezel mould coming up for you. Again, sorry, but low stock opportunity
that. Is so useful. So I use several shapes on there, and I use the wings again from the scarab, because that's an iconic thing in steampunk, is the winged clock, or the winged something or other, like a winged heart or something. I used the wings separately and added them onto the bezel, so...
Fantastic.
I really had fun, can you tell?
Yeah, you can see. Okie dokie, where are we starting? We're going to make the dragonfly today, aren't we?
Yes, we are, definitely.
Should we start with a message, did you say? Go on then. From Emily. Hi, JM. I'm using lace with the cogs and other steampunk bits. Oh, I can't wait to show you what I've done, Frankie. I always look forward to seeing you on. And that's from Emily.
Oh, thank you, Emily. That's lovely. Yes, don't forget to post it to the WAF.
Get that posted in, definitely. Definitely.
Put it on my page as well, if you like, because there are lots of people go and look on there as well.
Okay, fab. Let's get started then.
Okay. So I started off with the grey, what's this one called? The one with
granite.
It's a granite with the bits in it. And it's absolutely beautiful. It's got all these lovely sort of grey bits. And so I started off with some pieces that are about, how big would you say they were? About 2 centimetres across?
Yeah, possibly.
Something like that, aren't they? You know, a decent, what size bead would that be?
Oh, probably about a 16 mil.
Yeah, so
I would describe them as the lighter way to enjoy chocolate size.
Oh, right, yes, like that. Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
I do know what you mean. That's lovely, thank you, yes. And so what to do with the circles is to... I'll move these wingy bits out of the way for a minute, because I just had a play with that before. So if you roll at one end with your finger, you can see you sort of make it fat at one... Leave it fat at one end, and it gets thinner at the other. So... That's the sort of beginning of the wing shape. It needs to be about 2 inches long, something like that. And then you press it with your fingers to make it into the wing shape.
Okay.
I tried rolling it, but it doesn't go right. It's better if it's your fingers.
Okay.
So it needs to be...
Could you use cutters as well if you wanted?
You could do, but the thing about him, if you look at him, he's really quite sort of organic.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
And I think if you had the cutters... I mean,
almost too uniform.
Yeah, I think he would be, so I think, yes, you could do, but I didn't for that reason. So I need 4 of those.
Okay.
So I'll just do this one quickly. So we roll again at one end, and it leaves it fat at one end and gets thinner at the other. And then press it out again. And then I finish up with 4 wings.
Okay.
Like that. And the dragonfly wings are basically the same size and the same shape as each other.
Okay.
They're not actually much smaller.
So you don't have to worry too much
sizes. No,
good.
Not really. So...
So great for a beginner for that reason.
Absolutely,
then.
Yeah. That's why I did it like this. I think if you try to roll it and whatever, it doesn't quite work. Okay, so then I finish up with 4 wings about the same size and about the same length. They're not too bad, are they? And then I started off with a bit, probably, what would I say? Talking about a ball that was probably 3 times bigger.
Right, okay.
Because I've got his I've rolled it in the same manner.
Yeah, yeah.
So I've got his head here, and then this is his body, okay? And we're going to decorate his body with some strips of different colours, okay? So, I'll put his body over... No, I'll put his wings out of the way, because we want to do this first. And we want to... I sort of did it going from pale to dark.
Yeah.
right?
Got you.
So, but it doesn't really matter. So I had the blue clay and that lovely, what was it called, turnip. I think it's more like beetroot, isn't it? Don't you think? It's more like beetroot.
Yeah, I can see that.
But whatever.
Let's send them an email. Yeah. I'm not happy with this.
Can we please change it to, yeah. So all I did, I mean, it doesn't really matter about the colours. You can mix your own colours. There isn't a recipe for it. It is just a matter of, mixing different colours. Mm. I liked it different. Okay. So I'll start off with the blue. And you just need some little... Sorry, I think I've put that out of the way, haven't I? Move these over a bit. Some little strips. That didn't go very straight, Becky.
Do they need to be exact, or
no,
are we
not at all.
Going with
no,
it?
No, because they're going to wrap round his body like this. He's round his tail.
Okay.
And then we're going to be able to decorate them. So it really is just a matter of...
So it doesn't matter if one's thicker than the
no,
other or
it doesn't,
anything?
No, it doesn't, not at all. And it doesn't really matter what dial you had it on either, because it is just a strip. So I've got a blue one there. Let's have a purpley one next. So I'll cut that straight.
Yeah.
And then another bit here. Yes, it really is. It's a good one for beginners, this. But the thing is, you're going to overlap them, because it's going to look like a segmented tail.
I see what you mean.
All right. So I've just overlapped the one. Cut the end off.
Don't forget, always careful with your blades, obviously.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Yes.
Frankie is a professional. She won't lose a finger.
Oh. Becky spoke too soon.
Spoke too soon.
You are funny. Let's have a purpley colour next,
okay.
A magenta-y sort of colour next. And so we carry on like this, and they can get a bit wider as they go up, because the segments probably, well, they will on my dragonfly anyway. Mm. And let's have another grey one next.
So whilst you're just building that up,
yes,
I was wondering if you can build and discuss El Crochet on this piece, please.
Oh, yeah. Yes, yes, I can.
What weave did we do on this?
This is just the single crochet.
Yeah.
And after the show last time, we had somebody asking a very interesting question. It was, was I using American or English denunciations?
Weaves, yeah.
Yes. And in fact, well, the weaves are the same, but they've got different names.
Yeah, I see.
So
yeah, yeah.
It's an American single crochet, but that's how, as I said on my page, my daddy taught me that, because it's just sort of off once.
Yeah, it's
so
just
it's
off
a single
once, yeah.
Crochet. But yeah. I think that's called, is it called a double?
I do it the American way.
Yeah, right.
I do it the American way. So I would call it a single crochet.
But it's simply that you've got one one on your hook, go through your work,
yeah.
Get another one, so you've got two, go through for your again, and bring off once.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that.
Yeah. Fab.
So that's all that is, but I use that, you know, the lovely, it wasn't actually the Eslon on this one.
No.
It was the lovely long spools that we've had just recently again, that lovely purple in those. It's slightly softer than the Eslon, but I wanted something really quite substantial for him, because he is quite big.
Yeah, he is, isn't he?
So I actually put in the lovely sari thread with it, and that's why it's sparkly.
The golden section.
Yeah. And it, as you can feel, it's just a little bit heavier, isn't it?
It absolutely is.
Can I go home now, please? Because I want to order this.
I'm sorry, you're not going to have an opportunity to, because these are going to sell out within about a minute, less than that. If you saw this morning show, you will have seen that lovely Janet used this Eslon to do a very traditional knotted pearl necklace, and that is what a lot of these are going to be used for, I'm sure. If you are one of those people who have gotten yourself into and realised the money-making potential, if you do make to sell, on your natural, beautiful, knotted pearl classic collection, then that's what a lot of you will be using this for. Even if you love micro macrame, we know how great this is. It's great for a piece like your kumihimo as well. Great for your friendship bracelets also. It's going to be absolutely perfect too for things such as your gems distinction gemstones as well. Do you know what, take a look at them.
Oh, Don't tell me it's sold out.
840 metres. Your price point today for 840 metres is just... We're rolling it down. The price is going down. Shouldn't be this price. It's going to be. Taking it down to the biggest stash you've ever seen, really, isn't it?
Oh, no.
£21.95 for you today. That's all you're paying. Can I have my call screen up, please? Yeah, once everybody checks out, I'll probably have about four left.
Oh, please. So,
yeah, this is the amount you're getting. It's a fab amount. It's great.
It's incredible price, isn't
it?
Oh, well, never mind.
These are about to go. Once this goes, the kit will be back up. Well done, everybody.
I'm back with you.
I know, but I stopped to look at that. I'm sorry. Am I not?
Frankie!
I know.
Focus!
I know. That's the second mistake, Becky. Sorry.
It is a bargain. Too hard to ignore.
Oh, absolutely, especially like us if you're a crocheter. It's just, it's a delight to crochet with, isn't it?
Beautiful.
It's just a delight. It sort of goes around the needle
so
beautifully. Yeah. Let's finish off with a blue one. As I say, it doesn't really matter what order they go in because it's just segmented and that's it.
Okay. That's sold out. Sorry. Did pre-warn.
Sausages.
Oh, sausages.
Sausages and onions.
Sausages.
Yes.
Sausages.
So, you need to be a bit neater than I've been at the back, but I just want to give you the idea, okay? So that's given him his tail. And what shall I do next?
So, you tell me, Frankie.
I tell you what, we'll put his wings on next.
Okay.
So, let me move some of these bits out of the way. And so we need to have a pair just underneath his head. And all we do is sort of press them on. And then another pair just below that. Okay. And I think I'm going to have this one on top. I think the top ones, the top wings look better if they're on top of the... That's better. So you're probably better to put the bottom ones on first.
Okay.
And then on the back, to fasten them together, because it's quite floppy at the moment, let's turn him over. What I did was, I got my cutters and I made some screws. Somehow you need to, let me move him up a bit. Somehow, can you turn him over? That's lovely. Oh, you need to lift up, that's it. You need to fasten the two wings together.
Got you.
And so instead of just having a strip, I decided I would have what looked like screws because it is steampunk.
Got you.
All right?
That, yeah.
So the next to the smallest cutter in your beginner's pack.
Yes.
Is just the right size, okay?
Fab.
So, you know, it's simply a matter of, I think I had four, didn't I? So I cut four out.
I think you had six.
Yeah, I had four to do the wings. And then two to sort of fasten the wings to the body.
Got you.
Yeah. That's it. That's that way round.
Check out your baskets on that kit, ladies and gents.
It's an absolute fabulous kit. It really is.
I don't like naming and shaming people, Phil. Now, producer Phil's trying to get me to name and shame all of the people who've got it in their baskets, but I'm not that kind of person. Just check out.
Yeah, check out. Honestly, you'll have great fun with it. And for the Tim Holtz findings alone, it's brilliant. So, another two then by his body, to fasten his body to the wings. It's as simple as that looks. Not difficult, is it?
No, really easy.
Okay. And then you just need something. I like to use the... these are lovely, these ones, they're the ones that look like the dentist tools, all right? So I just make them look like screws by doing a line across. And it's always good if you can have them perhaps not parallel to each other. It really looks as though you've screwed it round.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean?
I know what you mean,
so
yeah.
If I do one here like that. It's sort of those little details that make it look... you know, a bit more interesting. And then we'll have a Phillips screw here, I think.
Yeah.
That's a cross one, like that.
Got
okay.
you. Yeah.
And that sort of joins it together. I turn him back over again and press him down so he's joined on. Okay. Right.
Lovely.
So we need to cover this piece up. Mm-hmm. And what I did was, you can see it looks quite broad, the little dial that I've used, the little mm-hmm. cog. Mm-hmm. And it's simply because I was really frugal and I cut it in half. So if you use those, yes, if you use the big metal cutting scissors that we've got, that will cut that in half. So I would put that in next. Do you want me to cut that?
It's up to you.
Yeah, well, it's
up to you.
Okay.
Have we got that the wire that we've used in here on today, lovely? You know, the normal copper coloured wire.
Do you know that's a head pin?
Is it?
Yeah, it's a head pin.
So we have 70 metres worth of wire in. I have got some raw copper wire coming up in that second designer inspiration for you, because I know
I did.
60 metres of wire. Thank you, producer Phil.
What's that again? Tell me again.
Nothing.
You're not having
I said nothing.
Again, are you, Becky?
Ryan, don't dob me in. Okay, I'm with you.
So you use these big cutters.
Yes.
Right? I've got really bad hands, as lots of people will know, but even I can use these to go through, but you just have to be careful. So a bit at a time.
Gosh, that's good, isn't it? These are your shears. I don't know if we have them in at the moment.
So, cut it in half.
Fab.
You've then got, I mean, you could, you know, then use parts all over the place.
Oh, over, yeah.
So it's a good way of making them go further.
Fab. Good tip. I love that.
So you can hide it away then, underneath here. I'm pressing in. I'll do one side at a time. Into there.
Mm-hmm.
And then into there.
Giving it a bit of texture and depth, isn't
yes, it? Yes, it does. I'll use a tool to help me press it in. And then we need to hide it a bit with another piece on top.
Okay.
So, and then I can decorate it. So that's what I did. So, I have my bendy blade. Mm-hmm. Please be careful, as everybody always tells you, get it the right way up. And then we'll have a sort of chest plate shape. That would be good if it was symmetrical, Becky. Why didn't you get it symmetrical for me?
Yeah, that's what I was asking myself that. Thank you for a long time.
So that sort of goes on there.
Okay.
That's a bit too wide, isn't it? So I can cut off that bit there.
So you're just getting it to be the right size.
Yeah, that's it. Yep. Do you need to do something else?
No.
Well, that's all right then, just check in.
No, don't worry, I'll let you know when I do.
Okay, that's fine. Right. So, press that down. Okay, so you can see it's coming together like that.
I see, fab.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Just checking that those are sticking down. So, what shall I do next?
You tell me, Frankie.
Because the thing is, you can do it in any order you like, really. But perhaps we'll make a couple of cogs.
Hopefully.
Because they're nice, so we can make those out of polymer. So we'll have that one. So this is the next one up. The next one up in that set. So make a...
Probably about a 1 centimetre.
Is he? Yeah, possibly. This is a centimetre, yes, so it's probably 1.5, actually.
Mm-hmm, fine.
But who's counting?
Me.
Oh, were you? Okay.
Yep.
Right, so this one, you need a blade. I'm using a craft blade, but, you know, you could use your sort of bendy blade or whatever if you like. I find it easy with a craft blade. And you can actually cut... little hole in the middle of it as well, like that. Let's take that off. Come off. Come out. didn't come right out. Let him off. Save all those because they make great screws. As you can see, there's a row of screws on it on the end of each of his wings.
Yeah.
So what I do here is take some cuts around like this. I won't do it all the way around because that's boring, but you can see then if you take every other one out, it makes a, I'll do another one there, it makes a coggy shape. Okay?
Yeah, I see.
So, can you see that? So, that's not my, that's better. So you can see, I've got my coggy shape, where am I? Thank you. Sorry, Pete. Alright?
Yeah.
So that's going to, you'll make some of those to go on his wings. And actually be quite nice like that as well. They don't always have to be.
Yeah, it's quite good that.
It doesn't have to, and you can do one on the other side and make that all cut out. So they don't have to be, it doesn't have to be symmetrical.
I see, yeah, of course.
Because in a machine it wouldn't necessarily be symmetrical, right? What shall we do next? Let's do the little coggy bit that goes on the top of his body, just there, right? So that one's quite small, so let's have that one. It's a nice magenta colour. Press it out. And with this one, you can use a pokey tool of some sort, and you can make it have... Ooh, have little, it goes sticky in the lights, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So that can fit on there.
Fab.
Okay. Fasten it down in a minute.
Yeah.
And then there's a slightly bigger one, mm-hmm, that's down the bottom. So let's have that in blue. As I say, it doesn't really matter. It is just about using the different coloured clays, because what I did was I used mica powders,
oh, yeah,
on those to make the wings all shiny and whatever. So I don't know if Phil's found us any of those, has he? Do you know?
Whilst you're getting that ready,
yeah,
I'm just
okay.
going to, as we can see on this, and as I did give you a helping hint, we've used kind of mixed colours with your pieces here. You've got kind of those gold tones, and one that's quite prevalent and shining through, of course, is those gorgeous copper tones that we've got in here. I'm going to bring you some copper wire right here, right now. You have got 60 metres worth here. Massive quantity, massive amounts, really, 60 metres, isn't it? But to make it even more special, not only do we actually have your 0.8 in that, one of the most popular colours here at Jewellery Maker, and actually kind of the world over for jewellery design, is that gorgeous copper tone, but also I'm then going to add to it 1.25 millimetre wire. Now, let me show you how gorgeous this wire is. It's absolutely sensational. It really is. This wire is super duper thick, sturdy. It looks big, it looks bold. But the fact of the matter is that we have put such a high content of copper within this, so it stays malleable. Have a little look at what I've got here. This is your 1.25, so this is our second strongest wire that we have. But it is so malleable. I don't want anyone to be worried about working with this, because look at how simple that is to shape. It is easy peasy, and again, it's still pretty easy for you to straighten out again, just using the heat from your fingers. If you've got your nylon jewel pliers, then blimey, you're going to get an even better look, aren't you? You have got so much in here. I know that you're kind of gasping at this. Do you love?
I love it.
Why do you love it so much?
Because everybody knows that I've got, you know, I've got bad hands, and mm-hmm, you know, I've got arthritis and so on. And I struggled when our wire was slightly less malleable.
Mm-hmm.
But this is just so amazingly malleable.
Absolutely.
And the 1.25 is fantastic to hammer.
Gorgeous,
I love hammering it. I get my whammer out. Oh, and the new one that we've had with the
textures.
Yeah, with the textures on. That is fabulous to texture that 1.25 wire.
You can make
really lovely flat jump rings, you know, hammered and whatever.
I know what you mean.
Really nice.
I know what you mean. I've got your hammer coming up for you in a bit with some ball chain copper wire, which copper chain, which will go great with this. Should be priced as £22.90. Not today. 60 metres worth of wire, an extraordinary amount of weight in this, especially with that 1.25. Your price point today isn't 22. It's £14.95 for you today on your copper wire deal. That is sensational, isn't it?
Why aren't I at home? No, I'd rather be here, but it would be nice. Yes, it's beautiful wire. It's really nice to work with.
It's a great price point, isn't it? And this is what I was saying before about how great it will go with the ball chain as well.
Yes, it's just exactly the right colour,
isn't it? It's just exactly the right colouring. It's fab, isn't it?
Because what's so lovely about this copper that we're getting now is that it really looks like rose gold. So when you put it with the rose gold findings, it really looks as though it's rose gold. I mean, I know it isn't, but it does look like it.
It does have that appearance, doesn't it?
It does, definitely.
I have got this ball chain and hammer coming up for you right now. Seems it goes so, so perfectly. We are getting low on that copper wire duo, so that's going to go off your screen in a moment or three. This is what I'm going to bring to you right now, though. Take a look at these stunning ball chains. Ball chains are fabulous, great for masculine jewellery and really feminine jewellery. Perfect for you to use to kind of give it a really gorgeous bracelet design if you can macrame in between these. It gives you beautiful fluidity. If you have a look at kind of the articulation on this, it's really beautiful. But then, especially with the larger ones, you've still got that ability, due to the stiffness and due to the size of the balls, to create flower shapes, etc., if you wanted to. You've got two different sizes of that chain in here. You've got your 1.5mm, which is this dentier one here, and then you have the 2mm. You've got a meter's worth of each of these, and I just love the articulation to this. I adore how this kind of drapes over the collarbone. It's beautiful. I'm also adding to the situation your chasing hammer, which we were saying is perfect to use with your copper 1.25 wire that you've just got your hands on. Our chase hammers are absolutely sensational, as we all know. You've got your dome side there, which will add a real nice texture to it, but we've also got your flattened side as well, which can kind of change the shape of your pieces. We've also got its beautiful weighting to it as well, and you've got that wooden handle too, which means it's comfortable to use, it's easy to work with, it's a lengthy handle, so depending on what kind of work you're doing, if you need to get it up close to you can, if not then you've got the piece at the end. But also, if you're hammering onto a metal block, you don't get the reverberation through to the head, which is much more comfortable on your hands. And your price point today for 2 meters worth of your ball chain and your hammer should be $12.46.
That's a good price.
Weird price. Very strange. That's probably because that's not actually your RRP. It should be more than that. £8.95 for you today. That's your actual price point for this. 2 meters worth off that ball chain and your hammer as well. Chasing hammer collection. Get it whilst you can, because they go great with the copper wire. But obviously, because it is such a workable and beautiful selection, we are getting relatively low in stock already. Can I have my call screen up, please, Phil? Thank you, Poppet. Do check out your baskets. My producer's telling me that I have 10 in baskets. And I've still got a couple of those wires left. Do I? 10 left, did you say? Okay. 10 of the wires left. It's going in at the bottom of the screen in a moment, and they go perfectly with this. Get it whilst you can. £8.95 for all of this today.
You'd pay that for the hammer, wouldn't you, somewhere else? I mean, you pay more than that for the hammer. And then you've got the chain. It's beautiful. Yeah, it's really gorgeous.
I'm back with you, Frankie.
Okay. Well, while you were away, I finished this sort of little nut thing, whatever it is, and the little piece that I said I took out of the middle of the of this cog, I've sort of put in them in the middle of that one, so you know, so don't throw them away.
No.
And then I've got some different bits and pieces to show on the front of this one to make it look pretty. So I don't see people use this one very often, but I've used it several times. This ziggity zaggity, whatever you call it, blade. So I'm going to cut a couple of strips of this with a jiggy jaggy blade. I'm going to cut a strip like this, not too wide.
Okay.
Sorry if my head's getting in the way. Right. And then I'm going to cut it down a bit. I'll guess about that large. I think I've got a couple of pieces on there, have I, Becky? Can't remember now. We can just have one up the middle for now. Okay. I should have tucked that under before I put the cog on. I'll tell you what I'll do, because if you make a problem like that, all you do is make another little, that one stayed in that time. It would, wouldn't it? That's it.
Yeah.
And where that one went odd...
You just pop your head back a little bit.
Sorry.
No, it's all right, just so the camera, the director can see.
Sorry.
Thanks, love.
I don't know if anybody's got these... But we don't do them here at the moment. I'm hoping that we're going to do something similar. But you'll have used these a lot in your paper crafting. And it just makes a sort of little indentation, which is really quite nice. Because then you can fill it, or you can put, you know, different stuff in there, whatever. All right. So, how far have we got? Oh, yes. Using the little spinners, the very tiny ones from the spinners that we've got,
yes,
okay?
They came in the kit, don't forget.
That's right, yes. So just two little ones.
Yours.
I'm going to, because I noticed when I put up a whole set of dragonflies, it said that it showed pictures of them with these funny little pincery things at the bottom. I don't know what they're for. Perhaps I should have looked it up.
Feet.
No, that's silly, I'm joking.
If there's any dragonfly experts, feel free to let us know.
Let us know what they are anyway. I thought they looked nice anyway, even if they're not real. So, sorry, it's hiding underneath the...
There we go, got it. Fabulous.
So, pop those into the bottom of his tail there.
Cute.
So it's coming along,
isn't it?
And then you need to take something like a pokey tool or whatever. I love doing this one because I like the grip of this here. And so I'm going to make some patterns actually down his body and his segmented tail. So I'm just going to press in.
Yep.
Because then when we use our mica powders, the mica powders will take that texture like that. So do it again on this one and go all the way down with those like this. You take a bit more time than I'm doing, but you can see what I mean, all the way down to the bottom of his tail like so. Okay, and then I also made some little marks along, little holes. You can take anything to use, really. It's just to give you texture and make it look as though he's mechanical rather than real, as if he'd be real looking like this. I wouldn't like to come across him on a dark night, would you?
No.
If you were sitting by a pool and one of these sort of came out of the water, you wouldn't be sorry.
We've had a text in just whilst you were in.
Okay, well, that's nice.
Dotting his body.
Yes.
Hey up, Nozza. Rachel Norris. This says...
Oh, thank you,
They
Rachel.
Are claspers and are used for the dragonflies to make more dragonflies.
I wonder what she means.
Oh. What time is it? 2:15. It's the way they ring the stork, then, apparently. Lol. Send in love, Rachel Norris.
Thank you, Rachel. You are lovely. Thank you for that. I knew you'd know something like that, yeah. So that I've used those for his claspers. They're claspers.
Ah, the old claspers.
I'm surprised you didn't know.
The old claspers. What are you trying to say? Why would I know that sort of thing?
Right.
Cheeky man.
So...
Thank you, Rachel Norris.
Yes,
you genius.
That was brilliant, yeah. So you can make the eyes exactly the same sort of way, and in the eyes, I actually, the middle of the eyes, I actually put some of the breads.
The pins you get with
the little pins that you
get. That's good.
In here.
That's cool.
Yeah, you can see them there. So it's just another metal bit, if you like.
Yeah.
Okay. So, is that enough of those bits and pieces? I mean, the people can sort of decorate him how they like.
How they like, yeah.
But the beauty of him, I think, is the way that you can colour him in. And that's what I really enjoyed doing. Have you got any mica powders?
We don't have any on the show today. No. We did have some yesterday, though, so I know.
Yeah, so
it's a lot of things that a lot of people own, isn't it?
Well, this is it. People do. And so I tended to use, I've used some of the blue.
Look at that blue.
It's gorgeous. It's in copper. And I think I used some of this reddy one. And this one, too. So what have we got here, Becky? We've got poppy. We've got zesty orange. I know you had that on yesterday, didn't you? The zesty orange. Something blue. Can't see what that is. And copper.
Okay.
Okay, so all I took was a thin,
dry paintbrush.
Yes. So let me move all this junk out.
Oh, wait, do we have some mica powders? We can load it up and put it on the screen
for you.
That would be
nice. That would be lovely. Thanks, Phil. That's brilliant. Because it is nice, and you do need to put them. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that colour. My goodness me. I love it. Looks edible, but don't.
Good tip.
So, once you've got all your decoration sort of on there, then you can take your mica powders and you can have really great fun. And so you can completely change the look of what you're doing. If you've got a fine brush... Sorry, is my head in the way again? This poppy is just gorgeous, and it's as it comes on, it's got that lovely orangey colour, but then it's got a pink afterglow, hasn't it? Like this. Let's do just off a bit. Let's do some bits down the side of this lovely. Did we say this was zesty orange?
Yeah, the copper one, isn't it?
Oh, it's copper. Yeah, thanks, Becky. Yes, it's copper. And if you want them to go on really, really brightly, you'll see in the next designer inspiration, I've used the blue. And what I did to make it really, really bright was I wet it.
I see.
Because you can use it as paint.
Yeah.
Mica is wonderful. And so here we go. And this is really all I did then, because this is the fun bit, is actually painting it. So let's do some of this zesty orange on his tail. So now we're going to go into these marks here, and you'll see that they show up a lot more when you put that on. So you can have it more on the one side than the other, tail it off. This bit is the real good fun. It's just, this is the playing bit, isn't it?
Yeah.
But this is the most exciting bit for me. Once you've made it, is then to decorate it.
Because that's what makes them all look different, isn't it?
It is, definitely. You're never going to make the same one twice. He's always going to have his own sort of character, which I think is fabulous.
Yeah, your zesty orange mica powder is at the bottom of your screen. The reason it's at the bottom is because it's only $2.95.
Oh, right, yeah, of course. So it's a singleton.
So we've got to be sneaky.
Singleton, definitely.
$2.95 for you
But look, I mean, I've had mine for absolutely yonks.
You've got loads of it.
You can't see that you've used it.
This is your zesty orange.
That's it.
Here.
It's beautiful. Shall I use that one again? We'll use it on this one. So that's it, really, Becky. Just sort of dusting it down.
Gorgeous.
And whatever.
And layering it up bit by bit.
Layering it up, yeah.
Now, whilst you're finishing off painting that, I need to ask you about this piece at the end.
Right,
because
yeah,
this is the one that we've got these bezels for.
Oh, brilliant.
For.
That is
extremely low stock opportunity on these. Talk to me about how you created this piece using these bezels.
Right. The clock, the little clock one, is the largest one. So the smallest clock fits into the largest round.
I see.
If that makes sense.
Yes, I know what you mean.
And I tried taking them out, although I know that that Debbie had said you can cook it.
You can bake
in,
with this.
Yeah, bake it in the oven as it is. And I use a halogen oven, and that's brilliant. You know, one of the ones like a dish.
I know exactly what you mean.
Really good. Mm. Before, I've taken them out and not taken her advice, and it was really silly because it's better if you do cook it, if you do bake it. Yes.
In here.
Sorry, I keep saying cooking. Mm. Yes, you know, it's like, put it in the oven, it's cooking.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
So the smallest clock face fits into the largest circle.
Okay. Yeah.
So, and what I do there, to get my clay right into, you really need to get right into these grooves.
Yeah.
Right into there. I tend to use this spoony spatula thing.
Okay, yeah.
Because that presses it, you can see it's sort of concave. And I press the clay really deep into that. Mm-hmm. And then baked it as it was. I also used the triangle and on the piece. I used I think it was the largest triangle to put one of those cogs in. And then the smallest circle
yeah.
for the very bottom. Thank you. And then for the very bottom one is the other cog that's completely filled in, and that's the smallest circle on the bottom. Now the other people, what I've tried to do in both these kits is to show how you can use what you've already got. So I know a lot of people will have bought the scarab, a lot of people will have bought different things, and the one that I've used for the key and the, oh, I got it out before, here it is. Remember this one, everybody? It's one we've had on lots of times before. I don't think we've got it on the website anymore. But, you know, if you've got other Carantha moulds, get them out and use them. So I use the little heart locket and the little key just to be something different on there. So get your other stuff out and use it, because it just all goes nicely together. Mm. Okay.
Get your hands on the last few of these, just £10.95 for you.
Invaluable.
It is wonderful. We can use this for so much. Once you've made your polymer pieces out of this, you can fill them with other things. You can even put resin in there if you want to. Once you've done and created your jewel enamel pieces, you can do that as well. What's the quantity on these ones? I've not got many of these at all. In fact, I'm in the teens on it now, aren't I? You have got £10.95 for you on this today. You've got 3, 6, 7, 8, 9 different shapes in here. There's so many of you coming in for this. Mm. Absolutely well done to completely everyone who's getting them today. These are your Sculpey silicone bakeable bezel molds, and it's just £10.95. Well done to
Brilliant.
You all. Well done.
It's lovely. It's a good price too, because it's more than that, I think, elsewhere.
Absolutely.
Okay, so do you want me to do anything else? Because otherwise, I think I've shown most
of things. You've shown all of it, haven't you?
I think so.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for showing us that, Frankie. What am I expecting from your second designer inspiration?
Well, it's a fish. Definitely going to do a polymer.
It's officially going to be amazing to watch. I have also got for you coming up after the break some very, very special pieces. Stay tuned if you want to get your hands on one of the rarest forms of an extremely rare diopside. I'll see you in a bit.
Oh, gosh.
Jewellery Maker are proud to announce we are the winners of 8 Make and Sell Jewellery Awards of 2014. We are happy to be the winners of the Best UK Supplier, Best Semi-Precious Supplier, Best Jewellery Making Website, Best Jewellery Making Kit, Best Jewellery Making Workshop Provider, Best for Jewellery Making Tools, Best Bead Brand, and Best TV Programme. We would like to thank all of our customers for making this possible, and thank you for your continued support.
Labradorite is an incredibly popular gemstone here at Jewellery Maker. As a member of the Feldspar family, this particular gemstone shows beautiful blue flashes as light hits the internal structure. The different layers that make up this structure give rise to really interesting colour play on the surface of the gemstone. The most usual colours we see are blue to violet, but you can also see flashes of orange and red. It's optical properties such as these that gives gemstones the edge, as these properties cannot be simulated by man.
Okay, today I've been on the wire macrame workshop with Mark Smith. Been an absolutely brilliant day. Found loads of new techniques that I haven't done before with wire and macrame. And we've made quite a few different items of jewellery to take away. It's been a real good experience. Great teacher, very patient with us, and we've been having a good laugh. I've done a bit of normal macrame with your satin cords and that, but with the wire it's a totally new aspect for me, and I've found it absolutely amazing.
We here at Jewellery Maker know how popular our 10-strand mystery packs have been, so we're bringing them back. You can get your hands on these completely random lucky dips for just £25. This works out to just £2.50 per strand, but be warned, it's while stocks last. Add this to your order and you won't be disappointed. Just ask for this code whilst on the phone to our call centre on 0800 644 655 or simply type the code into our website and add to your basket. Jewellery Maker, giving you the best deals on genuine gemstones. Download the Jewellery Maker app today. You can watch our Jewellery Maker shows live. View all the details of the item that is currently on air, as well as browsing all the items from today's show. You can also minimise the video or switch to use as a companion app. Get the Jewellery Maker app today and boost your viewing experience.
Hello everybody, welcome back to Designer Inspiration. My name is Rebecca Redican. It's lovely to have you on board this Sunday. Oh, Sunday. It's one of my favourite days. It's Sunday. Sam's just gone behind the camera. Is it Sunday? Yeah, it is. We're off tomorrow, you and I, love. We're off. I absolutely love Sunday. I hope you've got your Sunday roast in tuven, or you're planning on anyway. Maybe you're planning on putting it on later. We've got loads and loads of treats, not so edible but still delicious, coming up for you today, and one of those is in the form of Frankie.
Delicious. Oh, there you go. I don't mind being delicious.
How are you, love?
I'm fine.
Have we given you your challenge?
Yes.
Yeah, you've started on it.
Yes, I've started
we'll
already.
We'll give you a wee nosy of it in a bit. Yeah, are you having fun with it?
It's beautiful. I absolutely adore it. The colours are beautiful.
Gorgeous, aren't they?
It's beautiful. Something I've not worked with for a long time.
Oh, and
I've, yeah, I've not seen. I've had some in the past, but not seen it for ages. Have we had it on recently? Because I watch a lot and I've not seen it.
No, you're absolutely
You'll
right
find out later.
You will. You'll find out in a bit. I have got some of that black star dioxide coming up for you in a little bit. Do you want a little nosy? Go on then. Be honest. Isn't that gorgeous? They're coming up for you in a little bit. Promise you under £35. I promise. Let's get kicking off with some garnet, shall we? Take a little look at these. These are your garnet faceted Indian rounds. Take a look. Oh, Frankie. Garnet. Three words. Go.
Gorgeous. Red. Fiery.
Why fiery? That's a good one.
Because it's that sort of ember glow for me of a fire that you see in the garnet. And from here, it's not so much, although it is sparkling on the screen, actually in real life it really is fiery. It's the light is really twinkling off it. It's beautifully faceted, isn't it?
Yeah, isn't it?
So is that all right, my three words?
Yeah, well done.
Acceptable?
Won't lie to you, nailed it.
Oh, thank you.
In comparison to Fiona Potter yesterday.
I know, she was amazing, wasn't
she? No, she was
right,
not.
Though.
Don't condone that behaviour, Frankie.
925 was three words. You didn't say what she had to say.
Yesterday I did three words with Fiona Potter on some 925 findings. I said, 925 findings, three words, go. She said 925.
That's okay, isn't it?
No, it wasn't. The workmanship on these is absolutely sensational. I mean, look at those facets that we've got on there. It's that checkerboard faceting around each of these is what we are seeing, and that's why you get with the checkerboard facet, you're not entirely sure what it is. It's the effect that we've got on these, and it's those beautiful kind of squares that are conjoined next to each other that just run in line with each other absolutely beautifully. And what that does is it gives you this really interesting kind of undulation of light. Realistically, it's a beautiful, beautiful effect that we get from these. You've got 130 carats worth of your gorgeous garnet here. It is from India, so a really highly acclaimed location. Your price point today for this massive strand is just £11.95 for you today. That's all you're paying to get your hands on this, so get it whilst you can, because seriously, very, very rarely will we see a garnet faceted in this particular way, but mainly because garnet can be a little bit of a tricky customer when it comes to faceting, but also for the fact that actually when we are creating this cut in particular, there can be quite a lot of wastage. There can be quite a lot of waste on this shape in particular, due to the way that the squares kind of run in line with each other. It can be a lot of wastage on this. Get it whilst you can. Well done, Cheshire Chick, for getting your hands on it, lovely Lynn. £11.95 for you today. 130 carats worth of this garnet. They are graduated from 6 mil to 8 mil that we have in here. Gorgeous colouring. It's hard for you to see the colouring in the studio lights, but when you get it home, then you will really, really will appreciate that. That juicy, jammy appeal that these are giving to you. It's so, so pretty. 6 to 8 mil, as I said, and it's around an 18 centimetre strand for you today. Love these. Love stars. Why is this a money-making strand, you're saying, Phil? Because it's stars. Stars are very popular at craft fairs, aren't they?
Yeah.
What would you do with it, Frankie?
I think a nice idea is to put one on the back, you know, of a drop on your necklaces. It could be and that's a beautiful colour, isn't it? Could be, you know, your signature. They're lovely for earrings. It's really nice if you use your head pins long and have them dangling different sizes. And you can put them on, wrap them around, put them on chain, and let them hang. Anything that lets them move, because the shape is so pretty, isn't it?
Yeah, I like that idea a lot. Giving these movements is going to be fabulous. You've got 220 carats worth of these stars. 14 mil in size. They are the 5-point stars that we have here, but to be fair, you could pass them off as a flower, I suppose, if you did these with, say, your leaves. You have got that natural red colouring to this jasper, which is one of the most sought-after colours of jasper that you can get your hands on. I love the fact that these have got a slight doming to them as well, that then just breaks down to the 5-star points on each of them. It's really pretty appeal. Seed beads as well. 2 mil on these ones. Hello, Fleur, you gorgeous lady. So nice to see you. Pete, go away. Stop. You stop waving, Pete. Fleur's coming up for you later on, little love. These are your seed beads again of the same jasper. Beautiful, deep red, natural jasper again. 2 mil on these ones. 10 carats worth in total. We're going to go low, Phil says. Should be £12.90. Good price. We are taking it down. £7.95 is your price. What do you think of that, Frankie?
Brilliant. They are beautiful, and the colour is it's sort of like terracotta, isn't it? It's a lovely colour.
It is.
Really,
yeah.
Like it, yeah.
Love the stars it. Alone is £7.95, so you're getting a whole strand for free.
Oh, sorry. Do you know, I'm faffing about doing something else. I didn't realise you got another strand. Brilliant.
Yeah,
yes, gorgeous. They look really tidy. How big are they?
Great, great. Stock.
Absolutely.
Up, isn't it?
Sorry, I missed it. How big are the little rounds?
2 mil.
Fabulous.
Do you like working with 2 mils?
Sometimes. It depends if my hands are good.
Yeah.
You know, my challenge today's got some little tiny ones in, and I'm all right today.
Yeah.
So I leave the little ones until the day when I can cope.
And what do you think the little ones add to your pieces?
Well, they add a little bit more colour and a bit more texture. And I think if you were making the earrings I talked about, it'd be lovely to have the gold of the headpin, because I would use gold, I think, or rose gold, but certainly our lovely, you know, yellow gold would be nice with a headpin. Then one of those little tiny ones, and then the star. That would be really nice, wouldn't it?
How much would you be selling pieces like that for, Frankie?
I don't know. I think it's jasper, isn't it? So it's an unusual sort of stone. Anything £5-7 for a pair of earrings, I would have thought.
Fab. Bargain. Absolute bargain price. Well done, everyone, coming in for these. £7.95 for both those strands. So delight. Gosh, the quality of this is sensational. Rounds and hearts, the perfect combination. Tell me why, Phil. Money-making strand in your hearts. And rounds are great for basics, he says. You have got in here your two strands of So Delight. We can see the quality here. You know that you've got quality So Delight when you have this beautiful kind of even mottled effect, this kind of beautiful dispelled and displaced colouring just mottled across both of the strands in an even format. You're not getting one that's kind of almost pure white and then one that's almost pure blue. You're getting this lovely kind of mottled effect over each of them, which goes to show you how high a quality this is. It has been cut specifically to get that sizing. 525 carats. Just to let you know that the information in front of you isn't quite right, because on the graphics says 18 carats, but actually you are getting 185 carats worth of the puffy hearts. Obviously that's not just 18 carats on that heart strand, obviously. So in total you are getting 525 carats worth, approximately, on each of these strands. You've got that beautiful kind of willow pattern array of colours going through there. Pardon? Beautiful, Becky. Reminds me of blue and white china. Sarah, you are in my mind. I was literally just about to talk about the willow pattern, those blue and white plates. You know, the Asian blue and white plates of the willow pattern that depicts the story of a princess and her emperor father. And they have the mazes around the outside of the plates, those plates. It's exactly the colouring in here, isn't it? Absolutely the colouring in here. Should be £13.90. Rolling it down. Just £8.95 is your price point on these. That's a massive carat weight, isn't it? Over 500 carats worth. And you get these gorgeous colours. You get that beautiful mottled and spotted effect on each of these. What do you think of them, Frankie?
I think they're beautiful. And I think there's a lovely sort of almost like a patina to them as well. When they've got, what is that other mineral that runs through? Is it sort of like lapis? Has it got gold in it or what?
No, it doesn't. It's got no kind of metallic hematite or you know, inclusions running through it.
It's got that lovely sort of, some of them have got that lovely sort of patina to them. Do you know what I mean? Mm. I think what I would do is have like five of those at the front of a necklace, and then I would have of the rounds, and then I would make different size drops of the hearts just dropping down the front. I think that would be really nice.
I like that idea.
Yeah.
Really pretty idea.
Yeah.
Well done, everyone. Lots of multi-buyers on this. It's lovely to treat yourself. Here we go, we've got for you now two beautiful strands. Both in that kind of darker colour palette of the spectrum, but they've got beautiful shine to them due to the facets on these. $6.95 for both strands. That's good, isn't it? You have got these two strands, Snowflake Obsidian, and you've got your black striped agate as well. Of your black striped agate, you've got 120 carats worth for those 8mm, and the Snowflake Obsidian, you've got 200 carats worth on those 10mm. £6.95 for two strands. Frankie, discuss.
Ridiculous. And that's beautiful. It's a lovely, lovely stone, and the sort of way it's formed is gorgeous as well, isn't it? With the you know, with the bits of ash and so on falling and sort of making the patterns on there. They are like snowflakes. Love those.
Fab, aren't they?
Yeah, absolutely gorgeous. And the price is just amazing.
That is what you probably expect to pay just for the snowflake.
Just for the, yeah, you would.
Wouldn't you?
And it's beautiful too, is because they're really big, really big flakes, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah, you get
nice
huge
patterns. Yes.
Mm. Huge pieces in there, and you get that gorgeous kind of mottled effect running across it. And actually, due to that, they go really nicely with that soda light, wouldn't they? As a pair, and if you wanted to add a little bit of colouring to it. If you wanted to add a little bit of colour, then you could, couldn't you?
Oh, yes. Oh, lovely. Yes, they are nice.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
£6.95. Just to reiterate, you've got 10mm and you've got 8mm there in front of you. What would you do with these, Frankie?
Similar. I think you'd have to have a... I don't think I'd want a necklace of all of those because they are quite big. But I think, again, I'd have three or five. And I might even take some silver wire and make a... not exactly a bezel, because you'd have it looser than a bezel.
Okay.
But just have it so that you could suspend the one of the stones inside the circle
of
silver.
Almost a frame.
Yeah, like a frame.
That's
a good description, yes.
I see. Oh, that's a nice idea. And then you've got that movement too, haven't you?
Absolutely then, yes. It would sort of swing between.
Yeah.
Be really nice.
Mm, really pretty. Hello, everyone who's coming in and getting these. Lovely to see you, Lynn. And lovely to see Vivian as well. Kim's coming too. Patricia. Frankie,
yes.
I know for a fact you love our storage kind of bags.
Oh,
yes,
I do.
Why do you love them so much?
Well, for a start off, I love colour, and they are so colourful. But then, you know, the rainbow is always gorgeous, isn't it? But they're so useful for carrying things around and for storing things. I mean, I'm terrible at sort of keeping things tidy. And, I mean, my conservatory at the moment, after I finish making, is just full of stuff, and so now I need something.
Bomb has gone off?
That's a good description, Becky. Yeah, creative.
I know exactly what you mean. I have got here for you your mini portfolio bag. It's so high quality. You've got this gorgeous sheen to it, which means it is slightly waterproof, so even if you're going out in a shower like it is up here today, then it doesn't matter too much. It's not going to damage all of your jewellery that's inside. It's got a fab kind of sturdy handle on this. Just to let you know, I've not got a massive quantity on this. It's got a sturdy handle on there, which is great because it means that it's not going to cut into your hand, it's not going to dig into your hand. It's a really comfortable bag. I've then got your zip around the outside. You've got your double zip there. And as we open it up, you've got lots of different pockets. You've got your large viewing pocket at the front here. It's going to be great for your larger designs if you wanted to. You've then got this section, which I always think is your purse section. So it's if you are doing a craft fair, it's great for your spare change, etc. Or your notes in there if you want it to be kind of kept safely locked away. You've then got yourself your viewing window again, but it's got the opaque back to it this time to put in maybe your bangles or your bracelets or even your business cards. Same again on this one. And then lastly, but by no means leastly, at the back, you have got in here your three link loops. These are poppable. So you see, you can undo them. You can maybe hang a strand from there or whatever you will, and then pop them back together. And then you've also got the three little pockets here. Perfect for your tools. Now, one thing that can affect your pieces when you're working with tools and when you're putting tools in here, if you've got a piece of jewellery in here, is having the jewellery walking across it, it's going to scratch and rub. So what we've done is we've put in a reinforced section to over the top of those tools so it keeps all the rest of your pieces safe. And you can put your earrings through there as well, because it has got those holes in it too. Your price point today should be £9.95. It's not. Taking it down today. Just for my last few, that's it. £7.95, taking it down in price point today. Frankie's nodding with approval.
Yes, definitely. It's cute as well, actually, isn't it? Don't you think? It's a cute little bag, that one.
Yeah.
And it would go nicely in the big one that we've had recently, with the sort of, you know, the big
know
sort of
exactly
oblong one.
The big tote one.
Yes.
Yeah, I know exactly
it,
the
you know,
one
you could tuck that inside with bits and pieces in, couldn't you? Mm.
Shouldn't be that price point, but it is today. 30 left, apparently. Crimps first. I've got crimp pliers coming up for these. So if you want to get your hands on crimps and crimping pliers, get in now, because look at the amounts. Let me just guide these. Let's just guide them. 1,000 crimp beads. Why are these so essential, Frankie?
Well, you can't hold some of your bits, your jewellery together unless you've got those. I mean, if you've got your beading thread going through your gems and your beads, you need to be able to turn it back to make a loop, and that they're essential. If you've got 1,000, it's a bit like the red wire. If you've got 1,000 and you're not very good at doing them, you know, you've got loads there to practice on, haven't you? Because I have to admit that I was never very good at crimp beads, but I've practiced and practiced, and it, with the, did you say you got the pliers coming up?
I do.
I find it's easier with the pliers.
And why is that?
Well, because it with a proper crimping, yes, I've got those at home, with a proper crimping plier, what it does, it makes a sort of, if you think of a B shape, so at one side as you crimp it, at one side it's got a straight side, and then the pliers put in a little bump on the other side, a concave bump, so it looks a bit in section, it looks like a B. And so then you can press the one bit round the other bit, and it makes it very much more narrow to go into your crimp beads covers. Do you know what I mean? Didn't describe that very well, but
you
know what I mean?
It takes it from, if you squeeze a crimp bead down with chain nose pliers, they go flat, they can be scratchy, they can be itchy, they don't always fit into your crimp bead covers. They're not nice against the skin sometimes, obviously depending on where they are. With these though, it doesn't make it flat, it makes it more into a cylindrical shape whilst it's still holding your pieces. So it's a professional look, it's a professional finish, but it still does the job. These are at the bottom of the screen right now. Sorry, not these. These are at the bottom of the screen right now. £4.95 for these. We can't put them at the side of the screen because it's lower than the price we're allowed to go to. £6.95 for 1,000 of your crimp beads. And don't forget, they are gold-plated as well. Rose gold-plated. Okay, one of you, you love rose gold, don't you?
I do, actually. It's my favourite. And I've, you know, it's become fashionable now, but I've worn rose gold for a long time. You know, before it was fashionable. And, I love mixed metals anyway, though, so... You know, but the rose gold is really pretty. It's because I'm an older lady, it's softer on the skin, I think. Mm.
Yeah, it is beautiful, isn't it, really? £6.95 for you today on those ones. Hello, everybody. What did you say, Sweet Pea? 10 sat in the baskets waiting for you, apparently, says my producer Phil. £6.95 for these. They are 2mm in size. They're going to hold your wires together. Definitely. They're an essential if you are a newbie, because that's how we add crimps on. In fact, come here, you. I'm going to show you. We're going to be working with, in our second designer inspiration, this is what gorgeous Ms. Potter created for us yesterday, with kind of your liquid pearls and with the sprinkles as well. These are coming up in that second designer inspiration kit as well with Frankie. Something very similar, but a different array of colours and more array of colours. But if I just show you the back of these, you'll be able to see that we have used the crimps here to apply these. And these have been used with the crimps, crimping pliers, and you can tell that because they're held in place, but they've still got that dome to them. They're not scratching against the skin as I rub them. And also for the fact that we haven't had to actually use a crimp bead cover. Therefore, we're actually saving on some of our stock essentials because you haven't needed to hide these with anything. What'd you say, sorry, lovely? When you get the brochure and you're a new customer, let's have a little, and you get started. Yeah, let's have a nosy. How to use your flat nose pliers. How to use crimping pliers. Here we are. How weird's that first page to turn to? How to use them. So if you're brand spanking new to us today, well, you will get this book for free. And a DVD. How to use your crimping pliers is on page 31. This is great for all your newbies. Absolutely fantabulous. There's loads about business courses. There's some about gem art as well. Oh, I haven't seen gem art in ages.
No.
Have we stopped doing it? That's a shame. I loved that stuff. There's loads in here if you are new. There's all the DVDs that we have as well on offer. Well, vast majority of them. Oh, there's all about your findings. This is a good one. So it tells you in there exactly what your crimp pliers, what your crimps are. So the crimp beads, it describes them as crimp beads are most commonly used to finish off a beaded piece of jewellery, such as a necklace or a bracelet. The thread runs through the crimp bead and then returns back into it, forming a loop. Oh yeah, I see what they're saying. I see what they're saying here. Once in place, crimp beads are then crushed using crimping pliers or flat nose pliers to seal the connection. So you can see exactly what they are right here. Get them whilst you can. $6.95, bargain. Diopside times it. Diopside o'clock.
Gorgeous.
Now, I just need to let you know that these are sensational, they're stunning. Due to the lighting in here, these work best with an individual light source. So in here, that's the last thing we've got. We have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 different lights in here. And each of the main lights in front of us have four sets of lights and they are double barreled. So there is the last thing that's in here is a single light source. Now that means it's almost impossible for you to see that beautiful star effect on these, but you will be able to see it on the recording. Take a little look. Brand new black star diopside. That, Ryan's saying, that white bit there isn't too bad. That looks quite nice. But then when you see it on the recording, you'll see how it should look.
Oh, yes.
So you see that star? See that star, that four-pin star? That four-pin kind of effect we're getting? That is due to the fibrous inclusions of these. So this essentially formed back in ancient times by huge billowing volcanic eruptions, and essentially what happens is Mother Nature just did her best and she got all of these fibrous tubes to kind of sit parallel. Now what that then means is that the light gets caught in between these and you get this beautiful asterism. Now the asterism that we're talking about is when you get that crossing of the light, you get that star, which is of course where this gemstone gets its name from, black star diopside. Now black star diopside already is a rarity. I mean, come on, how many times do you see it on Jewellery Maker? Rarely. Very, very rarely. It's so rare, in fact, that, you know, I can only think of three or four strands maybe that I've ever had of it. This is actually the rarest form of black star diopside. The rarest form because there is the four star asterism. You can get six, which is the most common. You get six star asterism, that is the most common, which essentially means you get three lines that go across each other, making a six star point. That is the most common of all, and therefore the lowest price and the kind of easiest to get your hands on availability wise of your black star diopside. The rarest version is the 4 point. So that is two lines crossing against each other, and if you look at this recording you can see We have the rarer of the two. See it crossing there? It's like a shooting star. Just to let you know that in the picture, these are stuck onto a sticky tack. Obviously, it's purely to get them to sit up correctly for the recording, because obviously it's on the turntable, you can't get it when it's lying down. So just to let you know what that is. Your original price. That's going to be the price from now on. We are going to do a launch price for you. I have got 240 carats worth in front of me. That to me equates to 6 of these cabochons. You might get 6, you might get 7, you might get 8, you might get 5. It will all be around that same carat weight though. Treat yourself to these to get something unique and individual. We're going to give you back your postage and packaging. No need for us to do this, but we are going to because it is your launch price. £26.95 for you today for the rarest, highest quality of your black star dioxide. What do you think, Frankie?
Yeah, lovely. And you know, I've never worked with them. I've seen them when I've been here, but I've never actually managed to get any. So they really are unusual, aren't they? So what's it called? An asterism.
An asterism. Yeah.
Asterism. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful.
It's due to, because essentially these are formed by ancient volcanic eruptions, and all of the kind of magma and ash layers up perfectly in parallel lines, and all these fibrous tubes catch the light, and you just randomly get this absolutely amazing perfect cross of the light that you can see shooting across that one just now.
It sort of reminds me the chatoyancy of a tiger's eye. It sort of moves as the stone moves, doesn't
absolutely
it?
Absolutely agree with
in
that.
In a cabochon, it would be lovely just sort of moving gently on
totally.
Your chest, wouldn't it?
Would be stunning,
beautiful, yeah.
Well, so what would you do with these if you were to do something a bit steampunky?
Oh, steampunky. Oh, that'd be interesting. Mm. I think I would have to have some of the wire. Yeah. Probably not the copper.
No.
No, it would probably be the antique bronze.
Okay, yeah.
And that's going to be a treat. And I would probably make some sort of a wrap that would look like that was the centre of a cog or something like that, I think.
Okay.
If I was going to use them in steampunk.
Just to let you know, we are about to turn the lights off in the studio so that I can get a one-directional source of light onto these to actually show you in the flesh, as it were. Don't worry. You're absolutely fine. You're completely safe. Have a look at these. There you go. That's what you'll get when you get these at home. You'll get that 4-star asterism point. And you get that completely naturally. We haven't dyed these or applied any coating or, you know, added any glitter or anything unusual to these at all. All that is Mother Nature layering up these fibrous tubes, and that's why the light gets trapped within there and you get this gorgeous asterism across each one. It's not just that one, let me prove to you, you know, it's going to be across every single one of these. It's going to be all of them that we're going across. Don't forget, I have got 6 of these. Sorry, I'll do it the wrong way. I have got 6 of these in total, so you are going to be getting a real, real variety. Don't forget for you as well that you don't have to actually carry a torch around with you at home, don't worry, at all. It's purely because there are so many lights in here, and the lights have got kind of double tubes in there, so there's so much light kind of banding around these that it can be hard for you to see. But when you get this home, it'll be much better for you to see, it really will. What did you say, lights back on, did you say? Okay, we will be turning the lights back on in a moment, so do not be alarmed.
Oh my God, it just shows how bright they are, doesn't it?
I know, they are so bright. Thank you for that, Phil. Designer inspiration again now. Well done, everyone who got them.
Okay.
Nice little treat for you. They're going to be fun. What did you get in your designer inspiration kit?
I got pearls and... I got little bottles with lovely pearls inside.
How are they to work with?
They're really lovely. And I got the book plates. They call the book plates from Tim Holtz. So they're really nice to work with as well.
Oh, God.
And more clay.
Fab. Loads and loads of goodies coming up for you in this. And Cass is very glamorously winging it over to me. Thank you so much. Right, let's take a look at exactly what we're getting in here. Some lovely gemstones.
Yeah.
Really very, very pretty. Let's take a look at what we're getting here. Three strands.
You've got that really high quality, really exceptional, beautiful strand of red garnet. These are in your marquise shapes. 10x3
on those. Real nice jamminess to them. And look, they're kind of...
They're super.
Yeah, aren't they? They've got that eyelet shape to them as well, which is really, really pretty. And I bet it makes them really nice to work with.
It did.
Good. You have got in here 75 carats worth of this garnet. And the light, even the fact that you can see that kind of deep, rich red running through these, goes to show you the quality. Because we can't always get that with high-end garnet, can we? Sometimes it can look a little bit black. But you can even see the jamminess on here, which is stunning. I've then got for you 100 carats worth of your bronze-coated quartz rounds. These are the ones that are on the end. They've got that gorgeous metallic-like effect to them. And that's purely just due to a coating that we've applied over the top of a quartz, so it gives you this really nice appeal that Mother Nature herself doesn't actually bring to us. You've got 6 mil on those ones, and then we've got these pearls too in the center, chocolate shell pearls, and they are your 4 mil shell rounds that we have there. Delicate, but go beautifully with the colorway, especially with these. How are these to work with, Frankie?
They're brilliant.
Did you have fun?
So lucky. Yes, I did have fun. Yeah.
Good. You get loads, don't you? You have got here your Ranger's Sticklers. You've got the gold, you've got the rose gold, you've got the black diamond in there as well. These are your glitter glues or your paints, as it were. You also get your liquid pearl, onyx, garnet, copper and gold. They're all 18 mil in each of those. And just to show you as well, they do all have this wonderful precision nozzle. And the great thing about that is you can get into all these intricate details. This is actually the one that Ms. Potter used yesterday in her designer inspiration. Can you see them just glittering away in all these sections there to complete that paisley design? So it's great that you can even get into all these tiny nooks and crannies due to that precision nozzle in there. I'm then going to add for you your Tim Holtz. How are these to work with?
Oh, I love them. I've loved them for forever. I've used them a lot. And in fact, people were asking about the piece that I'm wearing. The base for this piece that I'm wearing myself is actually one of those. It's the one along the bottom, not the top. Yes, that one. It's that more ornate one. And they're just so lovely to... Well, you'll see when you come over. I've used them in as many different ways as I could think of. They're lovely for your scrapbooking as well, not just for jewellery.
No.
Have you used them in your scrapbooking?
Yeah, I have. Yeah. I've used, not the same, but I've used very, very similar.
Similar, yeah.
Very similar, yeah.
So because, of course, you can put words inside the spaces.
Absolutely. I've also got in here 3 blocks of your polymer. I've got your white, obviously. It's primo. But then... Kerry, what have I got here? Oh, you cheated! How dare you! Oh, see? They've fallen down in disgust. Cassie, what colour is this one?
Yeah,
oh, it's not. It's not that one, love. This is your Bordeaux. Bordeaux. Roll the R is whether or not you want to. And then, what about this one? What's that?
Elephant, I don't know. Elephant, no.
Elephant, no. It's concrete.
Of course it is.
But I like elephant better, actually. Elephant sounds much better than concrete. I'll send a strongly worded email, don't worry. I have got here, let's reiterate, you've got 3 sets of your polymer, you've got 3 strands of gemstones, you've got the Tim Holtz, and you've got 2, 4, 6, 7 of those lovely glitter glue and paints. Your price point today should be £40.30. We're going to take it down, though, it's not £40.30. We are going to roll it down.
really great.
Mm. Isn't it?
It is.
$24.95 for all of this. What saving is that?
Lots.
Over £15. £15.35 saving.
Amazing.
That is fantab, isn't it?
I pay that for the garnets because the garnets are really beautiful. The
good
colour,
quality, aren't they?
The colour in them is fantastic.
Really?
And that sort of marquee shape is really beautiful.
Gorgeous,
it's
isn't
lovely
it?
Lovely to work
And
with.
You've made absolutely loads.
Well, I did sort of go mad, yes.
Yeah, that's all right, though, isn't it? Why not?
Not
did you have fun with it then?
I did. I had fun with both the kits and it was really nice to use these plates in different ways. So I've tried to show different ways that you can use them. Mm. So
this is the one we're going to learn to make today, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Isn't it funky? Look at him. This is the one we're going to be learning today, but we're also going to be talking through a few different techniques as well. Funky. And we've used the Tim Holtz on the back of this, haven't we?
Yes.
I'm showing. You can
yes.
see it's used as the backing on this. We're going to be learning how to use this, make this one today. But you've made loads more. You've made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pieces in total. Huge amount.
I got clay and stuff left. A couple of the plates left as well.
That's good.
So I used most of the pearls. Used all of the garnet because it was just so, I used all of the garnet in the one piece. The last couple of ones that I'd got left I used at the bottom.
Mm.
But
say that again. Deborah in Pennsylvania loves the funky fish.
Oh, thank
Sounds
you,
like an
Deborah.
Axe move.
That's fabulous, yeah.
Thank you, Deborah, you lovely lady. Feel free to keep your texts coming in, 6777, so you text with your JM Studio. I suppose we'd better get started, you know, because it's 10 past already.
Good grief.
I know.
What have we been doing?
Gassing. That's what we've been doing, Frankie.
Okay. Right, well, you could make the shape, but for this one, I wanted him to be sort of oval. The other fish that we've just seen on the bare copper plate, which obviously doesn't come in the kit. I just wanted to show you what you could do, you know, if you've got other stuff at home. I use the round on this particular one, but I'm going to use this one's most people have got this. Well, lots of people who do clay, I'm sure, have got this because it's so useful. This cabochon one. Sorry. I'll keep it still. Right. So I'm going to use this one. Okay. So I want to fill it up with my clay, and as I say, I use the, because my fingers don't press very well, I'm better when I've got a metal spatula of some sort, so I'll press the clay in to get my shape, like okay. So. It doesn't matter how rough it is, because we're going to, as you can see, we're going to cover it up. It's just the beginning shape that we need.
Okay.
So fill that up with the clay. I had a lovely make the other day. It was half term last week.
Yeah.
And I still got a lot of my things out. Mm. So my older grandson came round, Jaden, and he's autistic, very high functioning autistic, and he loves the clay. So I bought around Christmas time one of those lovely 25 packs that you do of the clay.
I know what you mean, the big packs.
Wonderful, wonderful value. Yes. And I'd not shown it in before, and his little eyes came out on stalks. There were so many colours
so
to
much
choose.
There.
And so he had a great time sort of playing with the clay, and he's going to be 11 next month, but he loves winding it through the
clay roller.
Through the roller, yeah. So, yeah, it's good for him as well to do stuff like that. Okay, so take that out. Put that out of the way. I'm going to take my jacket off, Becky. I'm getting warm.
You're getting warm. I went to sneeze. No, I'm not. Gone.
I won't take
gone.
Anything
the pressure.
Else off
her.
Oh,
the
dear.
Pressure if it went.
Pressure of what?
Okay, you
me
know.
Taking my jacket off?
Yeah, Frankie.
Sorry.
You're funny.
I know. So now I'm just going to roll it a little bit to get him a bit fatter. But it just gave me a better oval shape. I tried it all sorts of ways and I couldn't get the ovaly sort of shape I wanted. without using that, what's the name, perhaps other people are cleverer than me, I'm sure loads of people are cleverer than me. Okay, ooh, don't do that. Don't get your blade the wrong way round, because it's not good. There we go. And then it's very similar to the way we did before. We're going to use different strips of different colours, and I've got, there's the colour itself and the white, and then I've mixed them, pinks and so on. And this one is the, what did you say, that was a Bordeaux?
Yes.
With some of the grey in it, and okay, that makes a darker sort of colour.
Got you.
You see, it's more Merlot, I think, that one, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
Could fancy a black
glove. Oh, I'd love a Merlot. It'd
be lovely, wouldn't it?
Wouldn't it? Sunday.
Really good.
Yeah. Fine.
Yeah.
Gone three.
Can't have one, though. Can't have one. Right, so where shall we start? I tell you what, let's do the let's do his fins. Because what I did, again, was use the, I don't know what we call this one, a zigzag tool.
It's your serrated edge.
Thank you.
No problem.
Thank you, Becky. I'm glad you came.
Yes,
thank
good.
Thank you. It did help, yes. So I'm going to sort of make a strip for myself like this by pressing it into the clay. And then I can cut out my shapes from that. So that gives me a nice sort of finny feel. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And so I had a shape that was, I need my bendy one again. For this one, for the top fin, I had one that was, he's fatter at the top end than it is at the bottom, like this. Like that. And then we see if that fits on, and it does. It goes there. So, am I in shot? Yes.
Yeah, you are.
Actually, this is quite helpful where I've got these markings on my board, because I'm trying to work around them, and that's sort of keeping me in place.
Love that.
Makes a change.
Mm.
Right, so we can put that on fairly roughly, because it doesn't matter what that looks like, because we're going to cover it up. And then when I've still got a little bit left, that one's almost a sort of finny shape. So I'm going to, well, that's not the bendy one. Bend that round. Around that way. So I've got one at the bottom. Like so. And then that didn't come out very well, did it? So we'll do it again. We'll press into it a bit harder this time. Because we need another fin at the bottom and then his tail. That's better. So let's do his tail. What shape did I give his tail, Becky? I can't remember. Can I just have a quick look? Oh, mercy buckets. Yes, I remember now. Yes, I sort of went, I know what I did. I took the cutters and the piece, and I cut a bit out of the end, and then another bit out of that end. And you see, that's how I got the shape there.
Yeah.
I'd forgotten about that. And then cut this off like that to make his tail. So let's have that in that way and in that way. There, right, that's his tail. Oops, did I stick that on there? That's not as good as I did before, but you can see the sort of thing I mean, I think. And then I've got another fin shape here that's left. And I'm trying to keep the bits sort of going downwards and outwards to make it look like his fins. So that one will fit there. Okay, so we've got those all the way round. Comes that. Alright, so that's our rough sort of fish shape, okay?
I see.
And then we need to start and decorate. So we want to cover up the bits we've got here.
Okay.
So we can just take all sorts of our different coloured clays. And as I say, it's a bit like the dragonfly. It doesn't really matter what colours you do, because it's going to look good anyway, because I just think he's adorable. So I'm going to cut some strips to put across him sort of here. Oh, that's not very good.
Which one do you want me to do, Phil? Bare copper wire, cool beans.
Ooh,
right,
nice.
I'm just going to squeeze in the bare copper wire whilst we're here.
Nice.
You've got a massive amount here. It's going to be a sellout within a very short amount of time. You've got 5 reels worth here. It's your 0.6. It's your bare copper wire. So this is the gorgeous, gorgeous wire. It's super duper malleable.
It's
super soft core. You love it, don't you?
I do love it, yeah.
Why?
Because of everything you've just said, it's even though it's 0.6, that one, you can really wrap beautifully with it and get more texture than you can with the 0.4, because it's so malleable. It will wrap beautifully. It wraps as well and as beautifully as the 0.4 in the other type.
So I know what you mean.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
You can use a 0.8 normal wire base and use this as your weaving wire, which normally you wouldn't be able to, because it's so malleable. The price is ridiculous. Like, I'm not even going to reference it, really. It's stupid. 50 metres worth of bare copper wire. You're not going to believe this, Frankie.
I'm sure I'm not. What's keeping us is in the suspense. No, I don't believe it.
I know.
I don't believe
I know.
It. No.
I know.
I'm just not going to look. I'm just going to carry on working, because that is ridiculous.
£6,095. If everybody checks out, I'll have about 2 left. Back with you.
Thank you. Why do you always have nice things on that I want to buy when I'm on here?
To really irritate you.
Oh, is that what
Yeah.
Well, it's worked.
It's not me, it's Phil. He works out what's on the show and when it plays and how much it is.
Phil?
It's not me.
Yeah. Oh, well, I'll let him off because he's lovely.
Aw.
Yeah. He always gets me my space in the car park as well.
Oh, bless.
He never forgets.
Aw.
It's like an elephant like that.
You're like an elephant like that, apparently, Phil. Cheers, he says. Cheers.
You're very welcome. No, it matters, though, because I can't walk very far with my bag.
It does indeed matter.
It's too heavy, so sometimes I arrive and I haven't got space booked, and then I feel bad. Where am I, Becky?
You're just on this fish.
Yeah, can you just turn him round a little bit more? Because
Right.
I mean, really and truly, you can put your bits where you like, to be honest. I mean, I didn't really have a plan. He was a bit like Topsy. You've heard of Topsy. He just grewed. You know, have you heard that phrase? No?
No.
Oh, right.
Tell me more, Frankie. Tell me more.
It's from a book.
Okay.
And it's the little girl in the book, and they say to her, where did you come from or whatever? And she said, I don't know. I just grewed.
That sounds adorable. What is that book called?
I can't remember.
If you know, feel free to text in. I just grewed. Grammatically, probably not the best lesson to teach.
No,
but
it's
cutesy.
It's cute, isn't it?
It is cute. Bare copper wire sold out.
I'm not at all surprised.
No, I only had about 40 of them anyway, so... We knew it was going to sell out.
It's a brilliant price.
Yeah.
You don't always do it like that, either, do you, in large chunks like that?
No. Just mix it up today.
Yeah.
It's a Sunday.
It's lovely. I've never seen that before. Right. Can I just have another? Could I put him sort of here so I can look at him, Bex?
My director has to yay or nay this.
Can I put him next to me, please, so I can see?
Is that all right?
Thank you. Who's directing?
There you are. Ryan is.
Oh, Ryan will let me do it, won't you, Ryan? He's going to shout no now.
There's still 30 people with Amber in their basket, says my producer.
Really?
Yeah.
Josh.
Check out.
Absolutely.
His message.
Uncle Tom's cabin.
Ah, right. Thank you.
Cabin.
Thank you, Jenny.
Jenny in Moseley.
Thank you, Jenny. Moseley. Yeah, just down the road.
Uncle. Tom. I like that.
Uncle Tom's cabin.
And she grewed.
She did. She grewed.
Must be a famous book then, if Jenny knows it as well.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just me.
Did you think it was me making it up? I think you did, didn't you?
No. Wonderful design, Frankie. I'm loving the fish. You seem to have an affinity with the sea, says Sue.
Oh, right. Do I? I don't know.
Do
but
you?
I don't know, but I do like doing the fish. They are sweet. And because you can go mad with them, can't
Is
you?
Is it because you've made an octopus as well, maybe?
Possibly. That's when I did the last fish, when I made the octopus. I really loved the octopus. He was gorgeous.
Yes.
And I used one of these plates again, this ornate plate. Used that to put him through. So it was the base for him as well, for
the
octopus.
Got you.
Because that then made it that you could hang him, whereas it would have been quite difficult to hang him up.
Got you.
By his tentacles, really. It would have. You don't really want to be hung up by your tentacles, do you?
No, thank you.
No. Mm. Okay. Right, so I'm going to make his teeth now.
Okay.
So, I just want to strip again. So you can see, it's really dead easy. There's nothing difficult about this. So, anybody
that
who's...
book came out in 1852, Frankie.
I know, it's a long time ago. But
I thought we were talking like Angry Caterpillar or something like
no,
that.
No,
oh, the Angry Hungry. Hungry Caterpillar.
It's a classic, and don't forget, you have to remember how old I am. I'm going to be 70 this year.
Are you really?
Yes. And so, you know, modern things don't fit with me, do they? I like old things.
I love that.
Except myself.
Blimey. Me. 80? That's very old, isn't it?
Harriet Beecher Stowe. Is that the writer? Anybody look
Maybe.
It up?
Yeah, it is. Good memory. Good memory. Who wrote The Angry Caterpillar? That's what you're asking next, isn't it?
Carl. Eric Carl.
The Angry Caterpillar. I made
Hungry
up.
Hungry Caterpillar.
Hungry. Yeah, Hungry. All right,
Hungry
then.
Caterpillar.
Fine, if you want to do the first one.
Eric Carl.
Was it?
Is that right?
Eric Carl.
Carl.
Stop it.
Is it right?
It is right. Frankie, that is absolutely ridiculous. You are wasted on this channel. Go to... work on a library channel as well, or how have you got a memory for that?
Because I was a reception class teacher.
Of course you were.
So if you have to read stories like that and make models and
that's amazing.
Papier mâché stuff with a caterpillar coming in and out of the apple and
that's amazing. You've got such a good memory. Such a good memory.
Not one dementia sets in. And I can't remember the name of a cog or whatever.
A cog.
Who are you?
Oh, wait, hang on.
Yes.
We've not got many of that amber cabochon left now, I've just been told. Hardly any left. 35 in baskets. Not that many to do get them whilst you can.
Right, those are his teeth.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Mm-hmm. What shall we do next? Let's do so. We didn't do this this bit around here on the last one, but it's the same sort of technique, and I'll use the white again. So did you see how I did the teeth? I just sort of did triangles like that, so that was dead easy. So I can use those, and they're just little balls that I'm going to roll up.
Okay. I'm going to bring to you now your steampunk inspired kit bundle.
Oh,
do you love it?
Oh, I love it. Yeah,
talk to me about each of these components, please. What do you like about these eye pins?
Well, eye pins are always useful, but you know, it's the colour of them that's so good, because they're not the usual shiny ones, are they? They're quite dull.
Yeah,
and that's unusual. That's really good, because you want some things to look matte. You want lots of... the secret for me of steampunk is that you have different metals, that you have different textures, and that you've got some sort of coggy-looking things or little... what are they called? I'm going to make some in a minute that open and close doors. What are
hinges.
They? Thank you. Hinges. And that sort of thing. It's a good job you came.
It is.
You see?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So, yes, it's, you know, it's the different coloured metals, and certainly the darker colour metals like that are just beautiful in steampunk.
And then what about with the antiques bronze wire? 0.8, 10 metres worth there.
Wonderful. You can make all sorts of things with that.
Like?
I don't know why it is, but I've got a thing about circles and, it sort of reminds me of clocks and parts of the gears and so on. And so I make a lot of circular things, and you can really, when you've got, what gauge is that?
0.8.
Yeah, you can make lovely weaving with that if you've got, could use the bronze with that. Mm. Not the bronze, the copper wire the copper. With it. So it would get a glint of the copper round through that or whatever. And they are gorgeous. Are they bronzite?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm proud I got that. They're lovely, aren't they? There's such a lot of texture in them. What's inside them, Becky?
Isn't it beautiful? Well, it's technically, it's not kind of an internal inclusion. Technically, it's the form, and because of the melting point of it, they kind of are brought together. So it's not like, say, your pre-night whereby you get the separate inclusions, or
beats,
even like
right,
with your lapis. It's kind of, can you see how you're getting the, you almost get your chatoyancy in some areas,
yes,
don't
I'm
you?
Yes, I'm with you. That's what
so
I was looking
of,
at.
Yeah. What would you do with these ones then?
Oh, I tell you what, when you'd made your wire piece,
yeah,
they would be lovely around the neckline, because they sort of look almost rivety. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean.
The colour of them and the shape.
Yeah.
Yeah?
And I like how the shape of these is quite unusual, because it does have that flattened top to them as
well.
Sizing on those ones is approximately 10 by 8, and you've got 220 carats worth. What do you think of these shell rounds?
They're lovely. They're very similar to one of the colours that I've got in the kit, aren't they? Perhaps slightly lighter.
Mm.
And they go. All of these would go beautifully with this kit, wouldn't they?
Oh, yeah. Fab.
I think.
Mm.
Yeah.
Do you think you can have shell pearls like this in steampunk? Because
they
look quite classical, don't they?
Well, I was just saying to one of the ladies in the Sunday Experience, and she was saying she wasn't really into pearls until recently, and then she suddenly discovered them and uses them and whatever. And I said, I mean, the classic piece that I did that really got me the job here was I did a steampunk piece with all